Welcome to the Barbarian Hour podcast, where we conquer the impossible. The Barbarian Hour podcast is presented by Barbarian Apparel. Here is Jared Opfer and Zeb Miller. Are you ready?
Hello, wrestlers and coaches. I'm Teague Moore. I spent 20 years coaching at the Division I level in the NCAA, 15 of those years as a head coach. During that time, I helped a lot of wrestlers and parents navigate the recruiting process. I've now opened my own consulting business to do just that, to help you navigate the recruiting process. There's a lot of unanswered questions. How do scholarships work? What program would be right for my son? Or better yet, what coach would be right for my wrestler? I can help answer these and many other questions. Feel free to email me or call me at the information listed below, and we can set up your first consultation today. I look forward to working with you and helping you make the right choice.
Oh my goodness gracious. We're going to be harnessing a nuclear power plant tonight of energy and positivity with the mighty cruiser, Mark Niemann. Mark Niemann, welcome to the Barbarian Hour.
Hey, great to be here. Freaking awesome. Love it. Love me some Barbarian. My son conquered the impossible this weekend. Did a great job. So when we talk about Barbarian apparel, we talk about conquering the impossible. And, well, here we are.
So your son, first off, what's your son's name?
My son's name is Joshua. We call him Josh.
Josh Niemann, yep. Qualified for the Division I state tournament. He's a senior at Watkins Memorial High School on the east side of Columbus. You yourself were a four-time sectional qualifier. I know you tell me all the time.
No big deal.
But, you know, you went to you were a cruiser,
yes,
right?
Yes, I am a cruiser. I wasn't. I am a cruiser.
Groveport Madison High School.
Man, you're good.
How far is that from Potascala?
It's about a 25-minute drive. So you're talking about anywhere from 18 to 23 miles. Get on the highway and just hop, skip, and jump.
Like 270 loop.
Yes, sir. We're a looper down here.
Family there still?
So my dad passed away. My mom's a snowbird, so she lives down in Florida, but my brother still lives in Groveport. The missus has family here in Pataskala, so we chose to stick around this side. So that's how we roll.
And you've had two moves, and I get it's Pataskala, but yeah. I'm going to call it, for the sake of being annoying, Pataskala. You've had two moves in Pataskala, right? In the district.
Yeah, we moved into it when my wife and I got married. We moved into it. So we went on our honeymoon. We came back, and I brought my Army duffel bag and my guitar, put it in the house, and I said, hey, honey, I'm moving in. So that was our first house, and then we've since moved to we built on 2 acres of land, and it's about maybe 8 to 10 miles away. The high school is actually in the middle of our old house and our new house.
Okay.
So it's pretty cool that way.
I remember you'd bought the property and it was just getting like cleared. You and I went to Legends of Gold together out in South Dakota with Terry Pack. Was that an awesome experience or what?
You know, it's crazy. I was just thinking about that today when I was thinking about how many states I've been in. I don't know why I was thinking of that, but one of the thoughts was, dude, I've been to North Dakota. I've been to freaking North Dakota.
And, South Dakota.
I'm sorry. Yeah. I knew that actually. South Dakota, we drove, it was 80 mile an hour speed limit. Might have been 85 or 90. But I get Legends of Gold stuff show up on my social media every now and again. And I'm just thinking to myself, dude, I was there. Kyle Snyder, Nate Tomasello, Zane Rutherford was there. We got to meet the packs. Man, that was a great time. That's a neat little thing they got going on out there. I don't know of Aspire Institute as close as it gets out here on this side.
Well, it's totally different with Spire, because Spire is this massive Death Star, and there's almost, it looks like about $1 billion. It's not quite that, but it's hundreds of millions of dollars of investment, right? And they're building pavilions. I get your point.
Yeah.
I get your point. I 100% get your point. They've added a 9 or 10 mat building. You know where the volleyball courts were?
Yes.
They put up a mass. They put like a 10 mat facility there.
That's insane.
Yeah, and he was hosting. They hosted like 8 mat tournament. They hosted like what replaced Fargo during COVID 2020.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, they did a heck of a job. I mean, Terry Pack is a visionary. He's not scared. Yes. You heard him talk. I mean, he's nuts too.
No, there's a little of what do you call that? Creative genius there. Like people, the normal doesn't get it, but it all makes sense to him, and he fires away when the vision gets cast in his brain. He will see it to the end. And well, Legends of Gold is the end process there. It's the start of it, kind of.
It's crazy because I remember you interviewed Martin Floriani in like 2008, right? Was it something like that? You interviewed him on the floor of the OHSAA State Tournament. That was my first coverage ever. And he's like, yeah, some guy walked up to me and just started interviewing me. And I didn't really know you at the time. I knew of you, and I was like, oh, that guy's a maniac. Yeah. But it was awesome. But to the point, that visionary maniac.
Yes.
Same thing. Floriani, Pack, they're the type of guys that like really drive wrestling forward, right?
Yes, I agree with that. Great call.
Just real quick, your background in wrestling, you were like me as a college wrestler in high school, right? You were there. It was good for you. You got a lot more out of it than it got out of you. Would you agree with that?
100%. I think that's the best way to say it. You know, I got into it because my brother was wrestling. My brother got into it in sixth grade. Well, we played a little mini-gritter football, and some guy came around to all the football practices with a flyer. And my brother looked at it and was like, yeah, I'd love to do that, man. Throw people off the ropes, clothesline them. That's cool. Wear a cape, a mask, all that good stuff. But we didn't realize this was wrestling. But a lot of our friends were in that football, and a lot of those guys transferred over to wrestling. So we were like, we'll do this. So fourth grade, I got involved. And, you know, I got to be honest, how do I say this? I wasn't bad in seventh and eighth grade, not just for a junior high wrestler, but just for a wrestler. I remember wrestling with some of the high school kids in the summer. And I remember it was work. Don't get me wrong. It was work. But to come out on top was probably 9 times out of 10 type of thing. I thought my freshman year, I think I really did very well. But, you know, we lost our coach, who was really the centerpiece, not lost him, but he stepped down from the coaching. He was really the centerpiece of the momentum that was growing there, Groveport Madison. And like, I don't know what he had, but there was a spark there that I gravitated towards. And it made me want to reach my fullest potential. My brother being on the team, and we had a full team of brothers or cousins. My cousin was a state qualifier for us. We had a set of brothers that were state qualifiers in my class.
Was the Fried Apples your age?
They were a set of brothers with us.
Yeah.
They came in. So we had the Cannons, the Niemanns, the Fried Apples, the Archers, which was a set of three because there was a set of twins in my class. Brian Landenberger was our cousin. His son now wrestles for Pickerington North. So it's weird to see all this stuff come through. But we had a lot of people that were all on, you know, like, really on the same page. And so, but it was going through. And then when Coach Nevergall left, it was kind of like, oh man, I remember when Coach Fronapple took over, I remember telling Rex, who was a 3-time state qualifier for Bridgeport, I remember telling him, man, I just don't know if I want to wrestle. I just don't know if this is really me. I was involved with it, but he kept me out. Rex did a great job of keeping me out. And, you know, I wish I would have committed myself more. Knowing what I know now, I was a November to February wrestler, if that. And, there's so much going on outside of it. And for a non-athletic guy, I needed to be more involved with the sport out of the season. So there you go.
Is that, you know, you really, I think you did a good job of being dad and pushing your son, Josh. You guys would go to the Campbell, you go to Colette stuff. Did you ever go to Navy since he's been at Navy? Have you been there?
No, that was on my bucket list, but it just didn't happen this summer. I think there might've been some COVID restrictions, But I think it's opening now. So moving forward, yeah, had my son been 2 years, had he been held back, he's going to graduate at 17, you know? So it's kind of like, dang, man, I really missed the boat on that, all the holdbacks and whatnot. But
I don't think you missed the boat at all.
I know you're joking, but I
think that you did the right thing. And I would like to send my son Thomas to kindergarten next year. My wife's not having, he just turned 4 in October. Like, yeah, he's not going to be ready. We can't do that. And I was like,
yeah. I'll tell you, man, it was
he gone sooner and on his own.
Yeah. Hey, you know what's funny? So when you flashback to your kid, man, he's in my arms after qualifying for the state tournament. And then you set him down and you start thinking, like, as the day goes by, you're just sort of sitting passing time. And man, he's just this little kid in diapers running around the house, and you're rough and tumble with him, and you're just being silly with him. My kid was a soft-natured kid. He still is a soft-natured kid. He's got a soft heart. He really loves you know, people and all that jazz. So the whole idea of getting aggressive between the whistles, it's a different mentality. But, you know, he did some club wrestling here in town, and I think it prepared him. We did some weightlifting, and I know that sounds weird, but Dustin Myers at Old School Gym, man, he really gets a lot out of those kids. He gets those kids to dig deep when the tough gets going. And I'll tell you what, we were out there, I want to say 3 months at a time, and there were some times in there when it was hot, and he was pushing those kids, and they had to dig deep. So, I mean, so the idea of really digging deep, it was not only Palmer's club, but also Old School Gym. Those two things, man, it's just cool. My son, not to get too rambly, but my son just wrote a letter to some people, Dustin Myers, Colin Palmer, Jeff Jordan. He just wrote a letter to these people. So I'm reading those, and now I'm thinking back as you asked this question. I'm just thinking, man, those are all the things that he just said in that letter. Like, dang, that's legit, man. What a good kid. You're right.
So Coach Gutcheck, right?
Yeah.
Coach Gutcheck, good guy. I was out there, actually. They just moved. They moved, yes. Not just, but like within the year they moved.
Yep.
Got a new facility. Him and Coach Corey. Him and Corey moved out there. They're at the Arnold right now doing what they do, beating everybody in pull-ups, showing off the abs, doing what they do, and they do a heck of a job with their supplements. And they're, you know, they're weightlifting bro line is what I like to call it, right? But they do a great job, and those guys are super engaging. They're Ohio River Valley guys, and I like those guys. Obviously, yeah. CP, Colin Palmer, right? Yeah. I mean, Colin Palmer's showing already that the sales is here to stay. We'll talk about some of their guys at, you know, 215 Division II is going to be a great matchup, I think, because there was a little bit of revenge there this past weekend. So that's an Ironman rematch, you know, at the district in it's Central District, right?
Yeah. Yep.
So we'll talk about that, but, biggest thing you think you've taken away from the sport, and then you handed down to your son, Josh, what is it?
Yeah, you know, that's a great question. One of the things I loved is the intangibles, because you got to learn them, but it's the life lessons that transcend the sport. I'm going to steal a line from Tommy Rollins. The merits of the sport are worth the time that you invest. Things like character, things like discipline, sacrifice, all those things that make people great in life, you find in the crucible we call wrestling. And I mean, I'm not even saying we did it 7 days a week all summer long. That's not what we did. You mentioned how you felt that I did a great job steering and, you know, motivating. I made sure to go. Colin Palmer's was 2 days a week. Son, I will always go on Tuesday. You got to drive yourself on Thursday. You've got to make it this yours, that this is your thing. And you've got to go up there on Thursday and you got to dig deep and find it. I won't always be in your corner, you know, looking there. So the point is things like that, the idea of, hey, this is mine, ownership, that's good. And, you know, I find myself trying to communicate that in the classroom. I'm a teacher at a local high school here, or a middle school, excuse me. And one of the things that I try to impress is, this is your education. I might be the teacher, but it's your education. You should want to take pride in maximizing your abilities as a student. That's no different than on the wrestling mat. I'm the coach, but you should take pride in maximizing your ability as a wrestler to represent, in this case, maroon and gold. My son is black and gold. You know, whatever your school colors are, you should want to represent that to the best of your ability in any arena, whether it's on the hardwood, whether it's on the gridiron, whether it's on the tennis court, whether it's on the wrestling mat, you should be the best that you can be at all times.
So you were in the Army right out of high school, right?
Yeah, that's correct.
And did you use the GI Bill to put yourself through college then?
The first leg of it, I was able to get 30,000 because I enlisted for 3 years. If you enlisted for 2 years, you got 20. If you enlisted for 3 years, you got 30. And if you enlisted for 4 years, you got 40,000. My first, 3 years that were paid for through the GI Bill. That's right.
So I don't think they do a 3 year. I think it's 4 now. I think it's the minimum's 4.
You could be right. It changed. And you know what's crazy is up until the point where I sat down with my recruiter to sign the paperwork, I was dead set on going 4 years. I ended up saying, you know what, let's just go 3. I honestly, as sure as I'm sitting here right now, my life would have been totally different had I gone for 4. I may have, well, number one, I would have gone to Bosnia. I don't know what would happen there. Number two, I may have reenlisted because there was someone who said something. I was in a mechanized unit, which is not infantry. I'm infantry, so you're supposed to walk everywhere. But because I got into a mechanized infantry, hooked in with tanks and scouts, I didn't experience the infantry as it is. And when he said that and he reenlisted, I thought, man, that's actually a great point. I did not experience the Army as far as the infantry is concerned, but I was like, you know what? I'm 2 months away from getting out. We had just got Bosnian orders. I'm 2 months away from getting out. I told my guys, I said, hey, bud, I'm 2 months from getting out. It's a 6 month out process. I've already gone through four. I'm going to go ahead and get on out. They were like, all right, cool. So, I mean, when you think about it that way, I mean, I wish they still had the 2, 3, and 4 option.
I think it's just four because I've had I teach a career class now. I teach career exploration and career-based intervention. And I've been bringing the Navy in each quarter because it's a 9-week class. And I think four is the minimum. I'm pretty sure four is the minimum because you can do, because you can keep up and for four at a time. But there's all different things. Obviously, the academy route's a whole nother route.
Right.
I don't know if you know this, but the academy kids do not get years of retirement for those academy years. Did you know that?
I did not know that.
I couldn't believe it because Kilgore, I went out to Air Force Academy and was hanging out with Kilgore one summer. And he was like, yeah, they don't get retirement years for this. I was like, you got to be kidding me. Because Connor Witt was Oak Harbor guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was a state runner-up a couple times. He graduated from Air Force Academy. And then Alex Bergman, George Bergman's son's Naval Academy, the two Oak Harbor guys, both state placers, good guys. Kids I've known since they were, babies.
Yeah.
And they did not get those retirement years. But you know the intention, right? If you've ever met Frank the Tank Workman, he went to Naval Academy. Have you ever met that guy?
No, I have not.
Total character. Hilarious. He was a captain in the Marines because the Navy people get to pick. If you're a Naval Academy, you get to pick Navy or Marines because the Marines is the infantry for the
Navy
or the ride, right?
Yes.
He chose Marines. He was in Okinawa. He was around a bunch. And then, he gets political and weird. Long story short, he got out after 12 years. And
but he
told me, he was like, yeah, he would have been like 3 years away from retirement had he got those 4 or 5 or 6 years,
however long you're in the academy.
Yeah, he would have been right there and could have gutted it out. But he was 8 years, But that's crazy. I think that's a great option. I don't know if you've seen the new Ohio standards to graduate. Military enlistment.
No, I probably haven't.
Military enlistment. And then there's a military enlistment seal that you get. You got to gain 2 seals. And military enlistment is something you can do to complete military enlistment to graduate from schools in Ohio, along with your credits. They've created this three-tiered system. It's a new thing coming out for Ohio's graduation standards for the class of 2023.
Okay. It's
very interesting. I'll have to send you the diagram.
Man, I would love it.
Military person. Yes. You support the military, and I understand it. And I appreciate that. We talked about that. Yep. You and I had a blast out in South Dakota, man. And then we drive to Omaha and fly out?
Yep, sure did. Yep.
So – good times, but okay. So yep. Josh Niemann will be competing in what weight and what division?
120 division one, 120 pounds. And really looking forward to it. Just to talk a little bit about it. He lost his first, he was up 6-1 in I think either the first or second period in the first match of the night. So we do a Friday night, Saturday night, or all day Saturday. Yeah. First match, he was up 6-1, and then sort of the wheels just sort of started falling off. And, as a dad, you're watching it. You're like, oh, my gosh. He ended up losing in the last second takedown. The kid took a beautiful double leg, put my son through the mat, and just like, that's two. I was like, oh, what just happened? What just happened? Flashback to Tuesday or Wednesday, my son was sort of going through the bracket like we all do. If I make the finals, I'll probably have this kid on this side. If I get beaten in the semis, I'll drop down and probably have this guy coming through. If I get beaten in the quarters, I'll cross bracket and I'll have this guy that moves my path. But dad, even if I lose in the first round, I think I'll figure it out. That night he lost in the first round, I sent him a text message before we went to bed, in quotes, "I'll figure it out, Josh Niemann." I was like, man, and to come through, he had to beat two sectional champs, one of which beat him the week before. We won in overtime there, just a stud sophomore coming through. And gosh, it was crazy. He's one of three kids in the Central District to lose his first round and qualify for the state tournament, which is really, that just shows guts, man. I just really am very proud of him.
So do we have to win four?
Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. And then your fifth match is your placement, third or fifth. But yeah.
How did he do in his placement?
He ended up getting beat. He got taken down. And man, to be honest with you, I don't even know if he was there. Like mentally, he was a state qualifier. He had done so much up to that point. Like he wasn't even there. And this is a true story. In December, he wrestled a kid that he wrestled for third. He lost to him 7-6 in what I believe one of his best matches of the year. He lost 7-6. He turned around and beat him at the end of January, 11-5. Oh, then wow. Then we wrestled him for third, and we lost 8-2. He got a takedown on us, and he got some back points. And it was just like, man, I don't even care. I don't even care. I'm the state qualifier, baby. Like, pin me. But he didn't get pinned. But anywho, that's where he was. And you know what? I've seen it before. I followed the sport long enough where kids just, man, they like their mind starts oozing out of their ears. And once they make the state tournament and like once they qualify, it's like the air is let out of the balloon. There's no more pressure. There's no drive. It's just like, I'm there, man. So yeah. I'm not hating on my kid for that.
I'm with you. So that's awesome. So he'll be competing last on Friday evening.
Yep.
Okay. So let's just get into this. We're going to do a little preview here, right?
Yes, sir.
We're not gonna try and get into the weeds too much on some of these weight classes.
Totally fine.
We'll move, but we'll start in Division III and give some picks and tell me what you think. And, you know, you can give soft picks, hard, I don't care. You do what you want.
I'm really excited about the Rossford sectional here. And I know that might sound crazy.
The Rossford district.
District, yes.
Yes.
The RO district. I'm telling you right now, Matten's a four. I don't know enough about Shore to say if Matten can beat him or not, but I am going to say this. That Rossford district is hammer district. If you make it out of there, you are battle tested and you're ready to rock and roll this week. So you're three or even you're four, but
okay. I'm just going to tell you about his third place match yesterday.
Oh my God, I can't wait.
This is actually horrible.
Oh.
So Matten was wrestling Hermes, Abe.
Yeah.
They were on the mat to start the sessions. Okay, so we left the there's a lot to this story. SoCon. We left the SoCon at 4 a.m. We were at the finals. I did the whole thing. I watched my nephew wrestle in the SoCon, did the thing, you know, did the interviews, watched all the finals, watched the true seconds, everything, videoed all the matches. We got up from Boone, North Carolina. We drove to Rossford. My nephew Owen was in Rossford, and he ended up taking third at 138D3. So we drove up, and we got there right as the placements were starting. Well, as I'm walking up, my phone's blowing up for my wife. Hey, someone just died in here. And I'm like, what? What? And then I hear, whoop, whoo, and I hear the squad. And apparently there was a medical emergency in one of the bathrooms and somebody passed away.
Hold on.
Who do you think sprung into action as he's sitting in the coach's chair? Who got up right as they're about to start his kids match? But Dr. Matten, goes and they were like, hold, you can't wrestle this match.
Yeah.
Doc Matten went and did his thing, and I think they were able to resuscitate the person. Don't quote me, but they were able to get the person out to a hospital in a condition that was not what they found him in. That's the best I can say right now, because I'm you know what I mean. I don't want to like speak to this too much, but
certainly
they moved that match between Matten and Hermes to after 157 pounds.
Holy smokes!
Dude, ready total to match.
Step on. Man, the emotions got to be.
Yes. So I want you to think like that is, and I don't know if you know this, he saved a guy. He literally saved a grandfather. Yeah. And I believe this was also a grandparent of some type. You know, I don't know if it was a grandmother or grandfather, but he saved a grandparent. It was a head varsity high school basketball coach who went to his first wrestling match. It was OAC 2019 at Perrysburg. They come in and get Doc Matten. This guy's flatlined. They took the AED off the wall. Saspy was in on this. Josh Saspy, Guy Seiko, we're both in on saving this guy with Matten. Saspy brought the AED in with Guy, and then they gave it to Doc Matten, and Doc Matten resuscitated this guy. They took the guy to the hospital. The guy survived. lived. Big news story. Doc Matten is a, I don't want to say notorious, but he's known for this. And I mean, what a member of the community. You know,
Mike there Matten. It is. The resolve to see a need and jump, spring into action.
Yeah.
We need more of it.
Yeah, I mean, he does take the Hippocratic Oath. Let's just
that's his job.
Let's not get too nuts here. He kind of has to do it. But
he's doing
but,
had to.
You know, he's on the show here a couple weeks ago, and I saw the boys. Zach Matten looked good. Saw him. I didn't see Drew. I think I might have seen Drew from a distance. I can't say though, because they all look alike. It might have been Zach. Dr. Drew. Drew's going to OU medical school. But just good people. So. That one hits home. When you bring that one up, that's awesome because the Mattins are such good people. Adam is the last Matten, and that is a tough draw for sure of Troy Christian. They're tough as nails. We already know that about those guys, right?
Oh, yeah. Now, listen, they're going to come out. So the winner's going to come out. Now, my guess is these Wayndale kids, man, Coach Stanley does a phenomenal job. Now, look, we're 5 minutes in, and we haven't even finished but one match. You know what I mean?
We're in the weeds thoroughly.
But I want to say that Wayndale's going to bring it, obviously. Thank you. They're gonna come out. So I think you're gonna end up with Heller versus the winner of that Matten Shorer match, and then they're gonna come out against Hunter Lacey. Who, newsflash, that cat is for real.
Hunter Lacey won that district. I mean, he's.
I'm telling you, I know that's what I'm saying. Like, jeez.
Yeah.
Oh man, that's great. Let's see who's on the other side. Now, Boggs is obviously good from Sandy Valley.
Sandy Valley has really built a nice program. They're south of Canton.
Yeah.
They're good.
Sandy Valley, and there's another school, South Range. Honest to goodness, I there are some teams in D3, and this is no slam on anybody. It's just my ignorance. I didn't realize these schools existed.
South Range won the D3 duel.
I know. They did. And when I saw that, I was with my son. I was like, son, I've not heard of this high school. So I pride myself on knowing high school wrestling. And another thing is I usually know the high school, the school colors, and the mascot.
Yeah.
Like, that's my thing. I had not heard of these schools, and that's on me. That's nothing on their team or anything. Like, dude, that's crazy. Well, there you go. Old brave Brandon Boggs, man. And, you know, it's interesting. And of course, you're going to see it at 106, but the freshmen and the sophomores. But it's interesting to me with the senior – the juniors in there. I mean, you got two seniors and three seniors.
Yeah, like, that's rare at 106, 103, 106. You know, I know we're old, 103, right?
yeah.
But hold on. Here's my picks. Let's go, Lacey. Lacey beats Adam Matten in the top semi, and I'll go with Abe Hermes in the finals, but I'll take Lacey to win it.
Noted. I like that. The only thing I would change is I'd probably put what do we know about Kimmel? Has Hermes
faced – Casper Cazo all day there, buddy.
Okay, no
Casper
problem.
Casper Cazo. Listen, I'm going to take a coin flip Abe Hermes over Casper Cazo.
Deal.
I'm going to take a coin flip over. That's all that is. Because Cazo – he's the real deal. He actually wrestled he was sixth last year. I don't know if he qualified last year, but he's a stud. I'm a Casper Cazo. He's a brunette trained guy. So I remember when he was little and his headgear were all like, we're bigger than him. I remember Casper Cazo. I mean, that's a coin flip, but I'm gonna take Abe Hermes.
Hey, I have zero issue with Lacey winning it though, man. You're gonna end up with a Rossford final again, probably.
Yeah, I think you got a Rossford final there. But and Edison could stick around here and become a problem or a thorn in the side of, but Legacy Christian's pretty loaded. I'm ready. You ready for 13?
Yeah, let's rock and roll. Hey, can I brag a little bit?
Go.
Cohen Becker, freshman district champ out of Heath. Cohen Becker is the third of three boys that have come through the Northmore program. This kid is a freshman and he is the district champion. Man, this kid's coming for heads, man. Just be ready. And I don't know enough about Nick Roberts at Plymouth. I wish I would have looked it up to see how he did at Marion Harding, but I would assume he did pretty good. If he's a state qualifier, I would assume he's pretty good. Eli Campbell is going to be Northmore's Becker's kryptonite here, maybe. But I'm telling you, Legacy Christian, are they good or what?
They're pretty good. But I'm going to go Max Hermes.
Yeah, that's fine.
Max Hermes won on a ride out last year, 1-0. I'm going to take him over to Cooper Shore.
I like it.
In the finals, Cooper Shore's just, have you watched the Shores wrestle?
Are there any Shores who are just crowned national champion?
Yes, they just won the nationals. But the Shores wrestle this crazy headlock, inside trip, boot scoot, kitchen sink style. And I think, now listen, can Cooper Shore catch Max Hermes in a flying Bondini or whatever? Dude, they got this Cooper. They remind me of my nephew Ian. They wrestle a lot like that, all of them. They'll do crazy stuff. They're gopher broke. Could he catch Max Hermes in that? Yes.
Yes, of course.
Billy, I don't think so. I'm going to take Max Hermes.
Deal.
Over Cooper Shore there. I don't know. How do you feel? How do you feel?
Hey, man, I here's the deal with Cooper Shore, and I'm not hating. Again, I'm not hating. When you got that gopher broke style, it could lend itself to somebody grabbing a leg and maybe lifting it when you were supposed to be going this way. So
what happened to Dake? Literally what happened to Dake against the Dagestani dude?
Boom. There it is. Exactly. He was going for the lift. He just put his arm in there, lifted.
The guy literally just blocked his leg, picked it up, did something. Yeah, it was like he Dagestan'd him. He caucused mountained him. You know what I mean? Like
I agree wholeheartedly. And, you know, 99 times out of 100, Cooper Shore is going to get that takedown or that throw or that inside trip. But the one time it doesn't, it's the one time that it couldn't go wrong, and it did. It's like, man. So, hey, I have zero issue. I want to see my boy Cohen Becker. But Max Hermes is the real deal. He's a sophomore or junior year.
Yeah,
he's
gonna Max be all right. Hermes, you know, like I said, he won on a ride out last year. Okay, won nothing on Legacy Christian. It was one of the Campbells, I think. I'm wrong a lot, but whatever. So, but Cooper Shore, man, I have a hard time betting against him because they just got this crazy gopher broke style, man. They're fun to watch. So, yeah, we're going to go Cooper Shore, Hermes. I'll go Max Hermes. 4-2, something like that, because he'll just control the match. He's so solid. Hey, I went to their Sandusky Bay Conference tournament, Edison's. In his first three matches, he put 20 on the board. He scored over 60 points in three matches.
You know what's interesting about that? That's almost as many matches as he's had. The kid is 54-3. That's 57 matches. If you double Cooper Shore's matches, it doesn't equate to Hermes' matches. Matches.
All right.
20.
If you would like to actually know, it is Hermes.
Hermes. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. 120 bananas. Because I'm going to tell you about this dude named Phoenix Kontos from Genoa. Phoenix Kontos had a come-from-behind win against a dude from Millbury Lake last week in the sectional, right?
Mm-hmm.
He technical fouled the guy this week in the district. Like 16-0.
You know what happened.
17-1, something like that.
Is that Sean's boy or is that Kevin's boy? Or?
That is Kevin's son.
Well, I'm sure one of them got a hold of him and said, hey, I think you should win better next time.
Yeah, I think that's what happened. But this weight's loaded with Dakota King from Barnesville, the Oak Harbor red and green.
The Shamrocks, baby.
Yeah, the Shamrocks.
Hey, is that top semi going to be lights out?
Yes. Him and Dylan Campbell will be
unbelievable.
But Patrick Reinecke is game, dude. Patrick Reinecke is game from Hawken.
Oh, yeah, he is. You know,
I think Mark James is coach.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, that dude's game. Watch that guy.
Hey, he's been grooming him for 3 or 4 years, by the way.
Yeah.
Mark has. And, you know, it's interesting. His dad somehow has my number, Mark James' dad, called me up and let me know that his boy was now coaching at Hawken. I said, Frank, I'm going to be honest with you. This is kind of weird that you called me. Like, what do you want to tell me? He goes, well, I want to talk to you about my son. I said, Eddie, I work right around Eddie. It's not a big deal. He goes, no, I'm talking about Mark. He's taking over a small little DT program. He's helping out there. Hawken High School. Look it up. Be ready. They're coming for you. I was like, thanks, Frank. I really appreciate the phone call.
This weight class is loaded.
No.
Gavin Caprella of Lima Central Catholics, a stud. Is he an academy guy? I think he's an academy guy. That dude's – I forget which academy
he's going to have. Phoenix Kontos at the quarters.
Yeah, that – he's going to have Kontos second round. Oh, my God. This – wait, Landon Duncan of Chalker. Hey, Landon Duncan of Chalker is the only guy on the team.
that explains so much, because my son was supposed to wrestle Brian Luff from Newark Catholic right there on line 12.
Yeah.
But his knee ballooned up to a bursa sac, and so he couldn't wrestle in the finals. Well, my son obviously wants to follow along and wants to know how this kid does. Well, he shows up in the state tournament. I said, son, I don't know anything about Hagen from Covington, but I'm sure he's pretty good. He's a state qualifier, but if he wins, he's going to have a kid from Chalker. Son, I have never heard of the team Chalker, but that's why, because he's not a team. He's actually just a member of the
– Well, no, it's a school. It's right around Warren, Ohio, and they didn't have a wrestling team, and I think his dad just, like, was fanatical about it. I think they got to practice with other teams.
Hey, there's another kid like that at 190, East Knox. Be ready.
Yeah, that's crazy. I don't know. Who do you got there?
Hey, man, honestly, I see the winner of the semifinal, 865, Dylan Campbell and Dakota King. I really see the winner there emerging against So here's the deal. You got a freshman taking on a senior in the first match and probably the quarters. Caprella is going to come out as a senior. Man, those bright lights are something else at the shot, man.
Yeah.
If you've never experienced that, then you might not be ready for it, especially in the quarterfinals. So let's give the slight edge to Caprella here.
He'll come out. I was going to just say Caprella. Canto is a freak, though. He's a Pan Am silver medalist.
Hey, he won the Rossford District, man. He's really good. Tech fall.
He's really good, dude.
He's on the way up. So, hey, whoever emerges down there, I'll say that quarter comes out. And they'll face the winner of Dakota King and Dylan Campbell, which that's a heck of a final.
This weight is loaded.
This is Saturday morning at 10 a.m. If you do not get there by Saturday morning at 9:30, you're not going to be able to watch this stuff, man. Oh, my God.
These guys are popcorn. Listen, I have a hard time picking against Dylan Campbell. He's a stud. I think his two losses are from Ironman.
That seems right.
Dakota King's OVAC champion. Patrick Reinecke's oh my God. I can't even honestly pick this weight. Let's say Dylan Campbell over Duncan. I say Dylan Campbell over Duncan. Oh man, Caprala. Jesus, Kontos. Oh my God. I think Kontos's experience is what's gonna maybe cost him, because he's young.
Yeah.
But yeah, I like that. I mean, that could go. That you could wrestle this weight 10 times to get 10 champs. I think you
probably could.
It's a pretty
good
weight.
You're probably
right. 26 yes, Division sir. III Ohio. What do you got?
Speaking of crazy weights. Hey, listen, as a Central Ohio guy, my son wrestled Wesley Wydick there on line 8. He was actually talking about cutting to 20. When you see him, you're going to think, I don't know how he makes 26. The kid is jacked, and he's good at wrestling. So yeah.
This weight's an easy pick for me, though. Easy pick.
Oh, I'm sure it is. Max
Easy
Short.
Pick.
Let's hope
Max Short, defending champ. I'll take
him. Yeah. Yeah, I'll take him.
Max Short via inside trip to a fall. There's my pick.
Over Wesley Wydick from Utica.
I'll take it. FYI. Yes. Yeah, I'll go Max Short with a fall. All right.
Yeah.
32, Division III. I'm going to go with this Hunter Long guy's gas pedal. He's gas pedal, dude. He's gas pedal.
Dang.
I'm going to go Hunter Long versus Alec Homan in the final. And I'll take Hunter Long over Alec Homan.
Two things. Number one, I have zero issue with that pick. I want to see Hunter Long meet up with Daxon Chase in the semis. Daxon Chase is a sophomore. And I'm telling you, that kid is phenomenal. He's a mover. He reminds me of, who would that have been? Just someone who can super duck. Carr. No, not Carr. Daggone it. Anywho, some college guy who's really good at super ducks. So, but that's the first thing. I want to see Daxon versus Long in the semis there. How about Monroeville?
Yeah, Monroeville's tough.
How about Monroeville? Were they in the state duels?
I don't know the answer to that.
Okay, were they at? Where were they that I saw them that I thought to myself, man, they got like 8 kids here.
Yeah, they're pretty good.
Good.
Yeah, they're pretty good. You know what? I'm going to reverse my pick. I'm going to take Alec Homan over Hunter Long.
There you go.
I'm going to take the Burnett Train guy. I'm going to go Homer on that one. 38. I'm abstaining from 38.
Okay. I'll pick for you then.
Go.
I'm going to go Cam LeCur, and I'm going to put him over I'm going to go Skylar King, and that's no offense to anybody that's on your Oak Harbor team, Owen Miller. But I think Cam is freaking good, and I think Skylar King is freaking good, and they're going to end up in this finals match, and Cam LeCur is going to win it to probably put the boys, the Legacy Christian boys, ahead by double digits at that point.
I have no problem picking the top half. I'll go Gavin Owens in the final. Gavin Owens in the final.
Eastwood, Pemberville even, right?
Yeah, he was a runner-up as a freshman to Zach Madden.
Well, he's the Rossford sectional, or district,
Fifth last year. You know what? We're going to go with a sectional rematch. Let's see Gavin Owens versus
Let's do it. I'm down. Hey, that Parker Knapp kid ain't bad, though.
You know, Cam LeCur, though, if you look at Cam LeCur, he's a nationally ranked guy. He lost an apronet at the Ironman to place.
Yep.
I mean, he's
blood run, right? Yeah, yeah.
He's obviously the real deal. I mean, he beat Zach Madden pretty good last year in the state final.
Is Zach's in Michigan now?
It's really hard. I mean, Cam LeCur is going to Campbell. So
yes, he is.
Gavin Owens going to Tiffin. I mean, obviously, it's hard to pick against that final, but let's go for me. I can't pick against Owen Miller. I just can't do it.
And of course you can't. I don't want you to. I want you to
sectional rematch in the final. Let's go. Whatever,
baby.
But I respect your pick. I mean, it's hard. I mean, Cam LeCur is the real deal.
Yeah.
He's a D1 guy, defending state champ. He's pretty good. Owens is a runner-up. Should get interesting. So I like your pick there, but I'm not picking against Owen Miller. I'm not doing it.
I love it.
44.
Yes, sir.
What do you like? 44. Listen. Brody Dominique of Archbold is a hammer.
Yes, sir.
Hammer.
Aiden King is not a slouch from Barnesville, and he's a freshman. He was a district champ. Listen, they're going to come out and they're going to meet. Now, my issue with Dominique is he's going to have to go through Bodie Campbell from Legacy Christian in the quarters. Yeah. So not only is he going to have to win that match, he's also then going to have to beat Aiden King in the semis. And then he's going to eventually come out probably maybe against Harris, maybe against Taylor.
I like Pierce Taylor because Taylor, okay. He's the guy who had – oh, my God. He had Casey Barnett beat last year at the state tournament in the semifinals. Casey Barnett did some Casey Barnett magic to him. There might have been a little bit of referee chicanery.
Okay. And
that dude's good. Pierce Taylor is good from Cincinnati McNicholas. I like him.
Man, Oh, man.
I got Pierce Taylor versus Brody Dominique.
Okay.
The finals, and I'll take the Northwest Ohio guy.
Of course you would. I'm gonna pull a curve. No, I'm going. Dang it, man! I want to pick something different. I want to pick Aiden King down here, but as a freshman,
whatever
man,
you want.
Yeah, I know, but as a freshman, it's gonna get tricky, man. You got to be ready for those bright lights, man. You come out of that tunnel, it's gonna be different. These kids are ready to rip your head off and kick it down the hallway. Let's go Taylor versus King.
All right. You always, again, you got that Bodie Campbell down there, too. So,
it's going to
be interesting. Will Stieber. I like Will Stieber a lot, but I got bad news for him on his draw. He drew into Gavin Brown. I have a hard time picking
Gavin Brown here.
I can't pick against Gavin Brown. I think he's your.
I mean, of all the locks, I think he's probably a top five lock.
Yeah. I like Will Stieber's on the other half. He's in the finals, but he's not, so.
Yeah.
Geez, oh, Pete's. I don't have a guy against him in the final. I don't even know to pick. I like Barnesville because they got the they're rocking the red and green, but
well, don't sleep on Aiden Helmke to Nora. I mean, if you're gonna get second at the sectional or district. Hey, is Steve any relation there from St. Paul?
I believe so.
That's legit.
Yeah.
Got good genes. Yeah.
I'm going to go Gavin Brown. I don't even have a finalist pick against him.
Man, that's terrible. You're right.
This is Andrew Myers' guy, Hustles from Liberty Center.
He's North that's Chicago. Good.
But you know what? I want to see Barnesville get a guy in the finals.
I love it. Let's get Tig out there.
Let's go Tig. Tig versus Gavin Brown. He'll get pinned against Gavin Brown in the finals, but he'll be in the state finals better than I ever did.
Dang right.
50. Listen. Tate Geiser's a stud. He was in the finals last year.
He's going to have Tanner Smith in the semis.
Jake Hurst is a stud football player from Mechanicsburg.
Nice.
Connor Smith is a reek. Dude, Connor Smith lifts the weight room. He don't lift weights. He lifts the whole room. When you see Connor Smith, he is a freak, dude. This dude from Gibsonburg, Connor Smith, my brother told me, because he's been wrestling with my nephews. My nephews are one's the same age as him and the one's older. He's like, that kid has looked like that since they were bitties. I was like, oh, my
God.
Dude, he's built like Kevin Randleman. Dude, wait until you see him. I think he was fourth. Connor Smith's a freak. That semifinal is going to be a bloodbath.
I cannot wait.
Oh, my God. That semifinal between Connor Smith and Tate Geiser is going to be a bloodbath. It's going to be a war.
And I'm
going on that one, dude. I couldn't even tell you.
I'm guessing Hurst is going to come out through Bauer. He's going to come out against Bauer in the semis. Of course, I want Christo from Northmore to make it.
Yeah.
But I'm sure Mylon Edison's got it going on. Heck, Ethan Cooper from Legacy Christian's probably pretty good, you know. But
Remington Bauer's a state placer, like a weight up last year.
Man, now he's cutting down. He's going to be big on day.
His dad was the Stiebers, was the head coach at Monroeville when the Stiebers were
gotcha.
There. So,
let's bring Hurst out though. Let's bring.
I'm gonna take Hurst. Hurst gonna make that final.
Let's go Smith Hurst.
Yeah, I'm going Smith. I don't know, man. Tate Geiser.
Geiser from Downton, baby.
He's really tough. So let's go Northwest Ohio Homer. I'm gonna go Connor Smith to Gibsonburg, but that's a coin flip between him and Geiser. I have a hard time. The Geiser dude's a stud.
Hey, that makes you want to tune in on Saturday
yeah,
night.
Yeah, that's going to be that. That's a popcorn one.
They don't get much better than that.
That is a top three final in that division, in my opinion. 120 is going to be a bloodbath. 157 is going to be a bloodbath.
That's great.
157. I'll take Connor Smith over Jake Hurst in the finals.
Dang, you took my pick. If anything, if I had to change it, I would put Geiser to come through against Hurst.
Yeah. Yeah, no, yeah, I mean, you could absolutely say that. I like – this next one's easy for me. 65, Division III, 165. The semifinal is going to be a bloodbath because the dudes roll. First off, this Hunter Andel's a freak from Garrettsville. I like him. How is Carter Chase? Is Carter Chase a stud from Pleasant?
Yes. Not only is he built like a truck, he moves like swift. Man, I'm telling you, these Chase boys, Daxton at 132 and Carter Chase, man, they are for real, for real. Like, it's crazy to me, and this isn't a knock because Burrow fan can't watch every single match. All he can do is get results. And when I think about this, I think to myself, he's got Carter Chase kind of low, in my opinion. And I'm thinking to myself, how can there be that many people that are better than Carter Chase? I've seen him wrestle. Yeah. I've seen him do things that I think to myself, dude, that was legit. For a 165-pounder to be able to do what he can do, like, I mean, I cannot believe there are that many people in front of him. I'm telling you right now, Carter Chase is the real deal. He will be a semi-finalist for sure. That Cameron Foster match is going to be tough, though. That Liberty Center
kid. Hunter Andel's a stud from Garfield.
Chase Miller works. They drive from Allen East. There's four Allen East kids that come up to Colin Palmer's. There are four of them.
Hunter Andel's from Garrettsville, Garfield. They're the G-men.
Nice.
It's like a Sherlock Holmes looking dude. Did you know that?
No,
they're the G-men. I swear to God, they got two real good guys. That guy's a horse. I'm going to take Andel, but unfortunately, Shadrick Sloan's the class of this weight class, and I think he knocks off Nick Alvarez in that semi. He scores a ton of points. He won the Sandusky Bay Conference. He knocked off Max Ray of Bellevue. His only loss this year is to Lillard from Aurora, which was a crazy match, but Lillard had an answer for everything. He scrambles so well. But Shadrick Sloan's the real deal. I think he's going to Campbellsville, too. So I like Shadrick Sloan.
Nice.
He wins that weight, in my opinion.
Well, if he can get past my boy Carter Chase, I'd love to see it.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one. All right. 35. I like – so here's the next G-man, Keegan Sell, another freak, both sophomores, up at 75. Keegan Sell and Connor Havel is going to be a bloodbath in the semifinals.
Hey, man. Dang. Hey, what? Bryce Keckley is in the quarter against your boy Selman. Hey, Bryce Keckley's the real deal. I know he got third. I know he did. I think he lost to CJ Smith in the semis at the district tournament. But he's no slouch, man. He's real tall. Not real tall. I'm 5'11", but he's probably 5'11", and his shoulders are pretty wide. He's a pretty built cat, man. He's a pretty tough kid, Bryce Keckley. But your point is, Sel's going to win, so I'm going to tell you.
Connor Havel's pretty good, dude. He won the pairs.
I meant in the quarter there. So yeah. Sel versus Havel in the semi, and you're going to probably have – well, we better have Bryce, CJ.
Keckley's 54-2?
Dude, I'm telling you, man, the cat is the real deal.
He got third. I think
he may have got third last year. Did he get third last year?
Who's that? Keckley from West Jeff?
Yeah, what did he finish last year? Did he finish?
I'd have to look it up.
Jeez. Well, you don't have this stuff memorized? Come on, man. Come on, I should have this stuff memorized.
Are you joking? We're flying by the seat of our pants here.
I love it.
Jeez,
okay. Don't fall St. John's. See, there's another team that was at the some of those river tournaments, man. There's a tough tournaments down
there. I will take Keegan Sal to win the weight. Close one with Connor Havel in the semis. Havel's a stud from Troy. And then I will take him to win it over. Let's take him. Other final emerging. Let's go with
Basil.
Man, it's hard to pick against a 54-2 guy who's returning state placer. Keegan Sal, that quarterfinal could be the state final.
That's legit.
Yeah, that's legit. I like Dominic Wetzel to go on a run.
Wow.
For Gibsonburg.
Hey, real quick, I want you to look at something in this bracket. Of the eight bottom half of the eight, there are seven seniors and one freshman. Seven seniors in that bottom section. Is that going to – I mean, not just because you're a senior do you make it, but, man, yeah. they're fighting for their last go-round.
Yeah.
It's tight. They're gonna pull from all their experience. That's gonna be a crazy bottom half. To your point, though, CJ Smith is your finalist. Clearly, actually, Basil. I think Basil will actually win the semifinal there personally.
Okay.
Against your boy Wetzel.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
I got Sal. Man, it's hard to pick against Havel. I've seen Havel wrestle. I've seen both those guys wrestle this year.
Okay.
It's nice when you have some data or have some eyeball.
Yeah.
I like those two Garrettsville guys. I think they're studs, and they're massive for the weight, both of them. I think they're tough. 190, Matt, going to be an absolute bloodbath because Logan Lloyd is a 75-pounder who went up to 90. He's a cradler.
Ooh.
Will Hash is a stud because my nephew Wyatt wrestled him and beat him in overtime. So Will Hash is actually pretty good, returning state placer. But I think the class of the weight is future Army West Point Black Knight, Lucas Stoddard of Berkshire. I think him and Logan Lloyd in a bloodbath. Logan Lloyd can absolutely cradle him and pin him. But Stoddard's massive for the weight. He's huge. Stoddard's dad is the superintendent over here. It's the neighboring district, Burton Berkshire.
Yeah.
He's from Berkshire. His dad was he's a superintendent. His dad was a former like regional pro wrestler, and his name was Stamp Lickage.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Listen, coin flip Logan Lloyd over Stoddard.
Noted. Oh, even though he's smaller.
But Stoddard's massive and he's super mean.
Oh, well, that's
really
good.
Mean. He wears the goofy headgear with like the head pad.
Yeah. Hey,
listen, Stoddard lost a semifinal last year to the dude from Archbold who ended up winning it. The Archbold dude dug deep. The Archbold dude at 182 dug deep two matches in a row. And that was when the semis were on Sunday morning.
Yes.
And the finals were set Sunday afternoon.
Yeah.
So, man, Stoddard should have won. He should have totally won the semifinals.
Hey, real quick, where were those at? Marion Harding?
Marion Harding. Oh, man.
Yeah, okay. So I was down at
Hillary. I don't even know if I can pick against Stoddard. He's tough, dude.
Hey, real quick, we mentioned how
Will Hash could beat Stoddard.
Bring it. Come on, Will Hash, Bidwell River Valley.
Hold on. Logan Lloyd's got to deal with this Tyler Knight dude. Knight was fourth last year. See, I know more about these guys because my nephew was at this weight last year. Logan Lloyd's tiny for the weight, but he can cradle anyone. He's going to have to cradle. Tyler Knight's a stud. Tyler, dude, when you see Tyler Knight, he's like a 190 version of he's a running back for Mogador. He's a stud, too. He is freaking jacked, dude. He's jacked out of his mind.
I can't believe I didn't see him at North Canton. I probably wasn't watching.
Dude, he's so yoked. The dude is huge.
well, he's got Tyler Knight has Blake Elliott, and Blake Elliott is the only kid on his team. He practices with a neighboring school district. He's the only one on East Knox wrestling team.
Jesus.
He's 30-7.
Dude, this Jaden Sapp dude was fifth last year at 195. He's a stud. Him and the Knight dude have gone back and forth the last 2 years. Man, Stoddard's got a good half.
I mean,
he clears Will Hash. B clears Will Hash. I'm going to go Stoddard. Stoddard, Lloyd, coin flip.
Deal. Hey, real quick, let's give a mad shout out to Owen Pummel from Indian Lake. His dad is his dad's all over the .net, a high wrestling guy.
Is Hayden's at Northern Illinois, right?
Yeah,
he's a champ last year at 70.
He'll be on the front cover. His older brother will be on the front cover this year of the program.
His brother beat Shadrick Sloan in the finals last year.
Did he? No,
that's what I'm telling you. Okay, yes.
Gotcha. There you go.
I'm going to go Stoddard. Oh, man. The bottom half is really tough with that. The Pummel dude's a stud from River Valley. Logan Lloyd. If Logan Lloyd can clear Tyler Knight, I think he can get – I like this Jaden Sapp guy too.
Hey, sometimes that quarterfinal match is the match. I mean, it's the way the brackets work out sometimes.
Man, Owen Pummel must be a stud.
A freshman?
Yeah.
Mr. Camp? I mean, at this weight? Like, remember when Chris Phillips came out, everybody was like, who's this kid winning matches at 171 as a freshman? You don't do that. Well, Chris Phillips did, and he was a freaking stud.
Yes.
Well, this kid's trying to do the same thing.
I'll go Stoddard over Lloyd, but Lloyd might struggle with the horsepower of Tyler Knight. Tyler Knight's a dude.
I gotcha.
Do you see this Tyler Knight, dude?
Can't wait for the quarters.
A horse, dude.
Can't wait for the quarters.
Oh, yoke. He looks like
Mark Niemann or
he just looks like the dude looks like he could squat a Volkswagen. He's a freak. Yeah, I like that guy. He was fourth last year.
Yeah, I like that
call. Logan Lloyd can deal with him and do something to him and get him in a scramble. He might get him, but man, the guy's powerful.
Would you say the winner of that quarter, though, comes out and clears and then faces
The Sapp guy's tough. The Sapp guy's tough. The Sapp guy from – he's Ravenna Southeast. He's tough.
Yeah.
Okay. He lost to the district final to Stoddard. I mean, yeah. But Will Hash – dude, like four or five guys can win this weight. Here's my five guys that can win this weight.
Stoddard.
Hash.
Lloyd.
Lloyd. Tyler Knight. Jaden Sapp.
Boom.
I mean, hold on. Could Aiden Pummel or Owen Pummel go on a run? Sure, maybe. But it's hard to do. He's going to have a hard time dealing with just Tyler Knight's horsepower. But if he gets lucky, Logan Lloyd beats him. And then, you know what I mean? Like, you know, you don't have to beat that guy then, right?
You can shuffle. Hey, you don't have to beat everybody in the bracket. Just the next guy. That's
correct. So I'm going to go Stoddard over Lloyd.
Hey, I like that. Let's go 215.
We got.
You know, this is crazy.
Listen, Trevor Stewart lost in the finals at 82 last year, okay, to the Archbold guy. Archbold guy, stud. He played this, like, shoulder brace game, though. I don't know if the shoulder brace game is going to work.
Got you. Well, he only has 20 matches right here.
Yeah, he's really good, though, dude.
Okay.
He's really good. He clears that top half, in my
opinion. Okay. Who's going to come out against? Jeez. I couldn't tell you one name.
That's a coin flip there, man. Couldn't tell you.
Pfeiffer Thomas? Is that our semi?
I'm going to go with Michael Lowe Amagador.
Okay. Is he built like a truck too?
he's not like Tyler Knight. Dude, when you see the Smith kid from Gibsonburg and the Knight kid from Amagador, you're going to be like, oh my, what is going on? What are they in the water at those places? Dude, they are yoked out of their minds. And they were yoked as smaller, younger dudes is what's crazy.
Gotcha. Yeah. So let's call Lowe to clear, and he'll take on Stewart.
Dude, any of those guys in the bottom half can make it.
Hey, real quick question. Do you remember Trevor Stewart from Detroit Catholic Central? Went to Central Michigan, maybe?
I know Trevor Stewart, yes.
Yeah, yeah. He was so he would have been 2005, 6, 7, maybe in that Detroit.
Yeah.
He had a broken hand at the Toledo St. John, but he was wrestling. And yeah. He just had it taped up real good. A kid thought it would be funny to fight hands. Trevor Stewart pinned a kid in 12 seconds, 8 seconds, and like 6 seconds. And then he wrestled this kid in the finals and beat the absolute pulp out of him because he touched his hand. For 6 minutes, he racked up points after points after points. He would constantly, like, he chose top. He chose
You're
bottom.
Just saying because this guy's got the same name as the guy at the top.
Yes, exactly. And that's my point, man. This kid, Trevor Stewart, I'm picking him because of the namesake. Yeah,
Trevor Stewart's that guy's the dude at the top, super crafty and gamey.
Okay.
The guy from Greenan is super. He was playing this, like, shoulder brace game. And it kind of just caught up to him last year at the state tournament. And he was just super crafty about when he was taking his injury time. Yeah. I am sorry, but it is very easy for me to pick heavyweight. I'm going to, with the returning, he was undefeated last year, 38-1 this year. Future Army Black Knight, Austin Kohlhofer. You're welcome.
There you go. Delta, make it happen. He's a big boy. I saw him at the Marysville duels, I do believe. He's a big boy.
Yeah. Listen, D2's not going to be this hard. I'm going to tell you that right now. Yeah.
Fantastic.
That's all. Do you have anybody clearing on the bottom half for Sim?
Come on, man. Jacob McLean, Liberty Union, get some. He's right down the street from me. My mailing address is the school district for this team.
Well, Liberty Union. You can have that Liberty Union guy. I'll take the Delta Panther.
Yeah. All the way out. And hey, I want to see him make the finals against your boy Kohlhofer. Deal?
Kohlhofer by murder. I don't see anybody get murdered, but I think he'll beat him bad. By pin. How about that? How about pinfall? We'll go with pinfall.
Deal. Okay. D2. One of two.
You ready?
Yep.
D2, I got some super easy picks. Barrett Great. Jordan next.
Hey, man, I interviewed Eric
Jordan him. Next.
I interviewed him at the Iron Man, man.
He Eric was... Jordan next. Okay.
Got it.
Bloodbath, 113 Division II. If you wanted to pick someone to clear the bottom, I mean, flip a whatever. I don't know. What do you want?
Yeah,
you
no,
want?
It's all about
clear the top. I'll go Javon Yarborough, clears against Barrett Jordan, loses to him in the final. That's what I'll go with.
Man, what a freaking match. You're right. Yarborough is going to come out against Barrett Jordan. There's no other way to say that. You're right. No, you're right. I think that's how it's going to play out.
I think the old dude from Ontario is a stud. There's been
10. No, he is. He is an absolute stud.
I'll take Javon Yarborough into this finals. Loses to Barrett Jordan as bad as Barrett Jordan wants to beat him.
Hey, Yarborough, what's he weighing these days? Is he
Yarborough was super undersized. I saw him this summer. Man, what nice people. They're really good people. I think he's up there into the hundreds now. I think he's into the hundreds now. I think he's into like 104s, 106s. He's starting to get there, but he was super undersized. He placed last year at like 94 pounds. He's really good, dude. But, Barrett Jordan's a killer. He won the Ironman. I can't pick against Barrett Jordan with a sound mind and body.
No, I agree with you. And I think Barrett Jordan might end up being about 130 by the time this match rolls around. So you're talking Barrett Jordan at 130 versus Javon Yarborough, who's trying to get to 105. I think I know who I'm going to pick here. And I think you're right. I think Barrett Jordan's your man.
Winner of the top half for 113, D2, 113. Billy Smith versus Cordy Cuervo is a semifinal. It was a blood round match at the Ironman, won by Billy Smith of Perkins. Smith lost a 1-0 match to Hermes in the league finals. I like Cuervo from what I saw of Smith at the Sandusky Bay Conference. I'll take Cuervo in the finals. And in the finals, I will take him against Louisville guy's pretty tough. West Holmes guy's pretty tough.
That's correct.
The Catholic guy's pretty tough.
London kid's pretty tough, man. That 12, that 13, 14 is going to be a match.
Yeah, a bunch of guys could clear that bottom. I'll take Cuervo on the top. Whoever clears against Cuervo. So I'll go with the West Holmes guy to clear against Cuervo. Okay. Cuervo wins the weight.
Hey man, I'm calling Heisey, man. Senior, 44-0, yet to lose. My only issue with that, I don't know what his matches were. Like, if he's grinding out 6-4 wins, 6-3 wins, he's going to be battle tested. But if he's pinning everyone in 13 seconds, if a match gets into the second or even late into the third and it's close, I don't know how he'll respond. So I'm just hoping that Heisey's had some matches that are going to push him. I'm going to pull him out against your boy Cuervo. Okay. There you go.
Are you taking Cuervo or are you taking Heisey?
Yeah, no, I'm taking Cuervo, but I'm
okay, in the finals, you're saying it clear. Okay. So 120. I will take Wyatt Nemitz. I will take Wyatt Nemitz to clear that. Okay. He's going to clear and beat Malachi O'Leary.
Oh, okay.
Wyatt Nemitz won the Sandusky Bay Conference. He's pretty tough. Brody Sukuch. That is Sukuch is what that name is.
Really?
Yes. Him and okay. Bellissimo. Him and Bellissimo is going to be a bloodbath.
First
that round. Is going to be – hey, that's a first-rounder to put down. Brody Sukuch is a stud.
Deal. Hey, I will have a camera ready for that bad boy.
Yeah, I will go with – I think Heisey beats Nemitz in the semifinals. What do you think?
That Levi Pigeon ain't bad. But whatever. I get it. Yeah, Heisey – hey, man, Crane is the real deal. He's a senior, and he is built like a truck. His dad was a state champ for Sheridan back in the day. Aiden King is a phenom freshman coming through. I recognize a lot of these names because they're 120-pounders. Strader. Oh, my son lost 6-4 to Strader. Daggone okay. it. McCrone will win that.
McCrone wins the weight, in my opinion.
Yeah, I think so. Is he committed?
I'm not sure.
Man,
maybe I need to be better at that. Yeah, need to be better at everything, but I'm not sure. But I'll take McCrone to win the weight.
Yeah, certainly. I don't have any arguments other than the fact that
there's a lot less parity in Division II.
Yes,
in my opinion. I mean,
you're right.
There's a lot less parity. You know what, man? The Ashland dudes are tough. I like the Ashland guys. Oh, I like them, but he's in the quarter with McCrone. I'll take McCrone.
Yeah. That's the only problem. I mean, it's a bad draw, Parabek. That's right.
26.
Let's go.
126, Division II, 2022. Who do you like?
If I don't say Cooper Rathburn, I'll get in trouble. But, hey, that Carmen's a real deal. Who's going to conquer the impossible here? Is it Bryce Kohler?
Listen.
Is it, probably Dieter. Dieter from Bowling Green. He's going to pull out some magic. Carmen. He's going to face Carmen in the top final. You're going to have Ellis taking on Dawes in the quarter down at the bottom. Hey, man, what do we know about Teandre Allen from Orange? He's only 10-2, Allen. Man. He's been spotted, apparently.
He just started. I mean, he just started the season. Obviously, there's something that happened. I don't know what happened for him to just have 12 matches.
And
seven of them, right? At least seven of them have to be in the last 2 weeks.
Right on.
Yeah.
So, know, conference, man. Maybe.
I like the BG guy. I saw a couple BG guys.
Okay.
They were massive for the weights. There's another dude coming up from BG.
Yeah.
57-pounder. That dude's a freak. He's a stud. So, BG's like, you know, it's just north of, or just south of Perrysburg and Toledo. So, I got to see a couple of them. I was impressed with them. I will stick with. I like the Dieter guy. I like the Dieter guy from BG. I want to see him and Teandre Allen in the final.
Okay.
That's what I want to see, and I will take the BG guy.
Deal. I'm going to pull Cooper Rathburn to come out. Cooper Rathburn in the semis against Ellis. Because my boy Cooper Rathburn, that's why. And then we'll put Ellis in there just because I'm not so much of a homer.
Listen. Bryce Kohler and Dylan Rhodes, whoever wins that match, that could be your finalist.
Either one of those guys
can win. Louisville's got a great team. Obviously, Graham. We know what Graham. We know their schedule. We know why the guys got 10 losses. We know two
they're
of them
are Iron Man.
We know that they've got a hammer schedule. I mean, so those two guys could make the final.
Yeah.
I just like the Dieter guy from what I've seen of those guys.
Okay.
So I'll stick with the – because I just, quite frankly, this one's out of ignorance, right? Only one of the guys, so it's like – but I'll take Teandre Allen into the finals.
Deal.
But Rathburn could beat him absolutely, right? I mean,
yeah.
So a lot of coin flips here. A lot of guys can win these. These are wide open weights, I think. In my
opinion. Yeah, I think 126. So let's not get bogged down there. Let's get move on to 132.
I got Pablo Castro, the future Golden Flash.
I will
take Pablo Castro to clear the top half.
And I'll take Dave McClellan to clear out the bottom.
All right. I will take Donovan Pays of Streetsboro to clear the bottom half versus Pablo Castro. I've got Pablo Castro, the future Golden Flash for Kent State of Louisville, winning the weight class. We don't even need to get into the weeds on that one at all.
No.
A lot of homer picks coming here in 38, brother, just so you know. A lot of homer picks coming. You ready?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's a horrible homer pick for me. But I like Lance. Okay, on the top half. Top half, first off, there's somebody. This one sucks because, I'm going to take Brent Minnick to clear the top. From Tiffin Columbian.
I gotcha.
Jeez. And then I like the Overmeyer dude from Clyde a lot, but it's, I don't know, man. The Overmeyer guy just wrestles real hard. So, yeah, I like that. I like Lance Overmeyer. But Lawson Grimes pretty tough. Lawson Grimes is super strong.
Ooh.
Lawson Grimes jacked. Okay.
That's good to know.
I'm gonna go with, but Jack Sparrow's tough from West G. I like Lance Overmeyer to clear Lawson Grimes in the semifinals, even though that they think they've met a couple different times. I like Lance Overmeyer in the finals. Brett Minnick knocks off Lance Overmeyer.
Not a problem. I will say this. I'll say Connor Roback set himself up nice. Now I don't like hearing you talk about Grime being really crazy strong, you know what I mean?
Crazy strong, dude. Yeah. Super jacked, crazy strong.
Connor Roback has definitely, he's moved up a couple weight classes, and I would say that he won his district. That really sets him up nice. So I think the biggest thing for me is, hey, I'm a homer, so I'm going to go Connor Roback winning that over Grime. And, however, I do, for some reason, I remember seeing Overmeyer. I don't know why, from Clyde.
Yeah.
And I can see him taking out that. See, that's crazy. He's going to take out two seniors to get to that semifinal. Whew, man. Oh, my gosh, dude.
And if you look, like, Aiden Rush from DeSales.
Yeah.
This is what's starting to come for, you know, DeSales.
Oh,
right?
Yes.
To build.
Yep, they got two freshmen coming later in this state.
Listen, worldwide. You got to tell me. I don't know. Is Mark Emmerling from Beaver or Beaver Local?
I would assume it's Beaver Local, but
yeah.
Are there two high schools named Beaver? Like,
no, maybe it's Beaver Local is the only one I know.
Yeah,
and,
me too.
And he's from his district is, what do you call it?
Maybe out east somewhere, yeah.
Yeah, it's an east district. What is GA?
Gallia Academy.
I don't think that's it, though.
Yeah, it is.
No, they didn't host a district. Shut up. Now I'm going to look. Now you've piqued my curiosity. We got to know that one. We got to know that one. All right. I'm going to tell you right now because we got to know that. We actually got to know that because it's important, obviously, where the guy's from. It is.
Geauga?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, okay. You were right. They did host it. You were right.
Wait.
Hold on. That's the Central District then.
No, we're Wilmington.
You're Wilmington? They sent you guys to Wilmington?
Yes.
Where's Galea Academy at?
Hey, they go to Licking Valley, which is way out east. It's like
Galea Academy at? I'm asking.
Oh, I don't know where Galea Academy is.
Galea, I don't even know where that is. Or Galea, Galea. I don't even know where's. So I knew Norwalk, Perry, and Wilmington. I was like, okay.
Yeah.
But that's the east. It's like this, the Athens.
Right. That south.
Out of east corridor, of, south and east I-70, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. And 77. Okay. Okay. So that's hard, though, but I like Lance Overmeyer. Lance Overmeyer, Brett Minnick wins the state title over Lance Overmeyer. Rematch of the state, the SBC. All right, 44, you ready?
Hey, real quick, I want to comment real quick on that 138. Hofarth versus Grime. Probably that's your bloodbath first. So every weight class has one match in the first round that is the, like, sticks out above the most.
Yes, bloodbath. Absolutely agree. Yeah. Going to be a bloodbath. That's a great first round matchup. I agree. 44. Yeah, 44. Listen to me. 44. This one got all jammed up and messed up. I cannot pick against Nolan Gessler. I understand that
dude.
I understand. I really have a hard time picking against Nolan Gessler here.
Now, did he win his district?
No. Well, Younger won the district.
Yeah, doggone right he did.
Younger won the district. Hold on. Let me get the actual result. Let me tell you the actual result.
I would love to know the actual result.
It was 5-2. Wilmington, right? So here we go. You ready?
Yep.
Yeah, this is nice to dig into the result a little bit, right?
Yes.
So 44. I'm looking at the result. 5-2 over Gessler.
Boom.
I'm going to take the game returning state champion to do what he does. He'll be massive after the semis going into Sunday. I got to go with Gessler.
Hey, real quick.
I can't pick against Nolan Gessler. I'm sorry.
That's okay.
I'll take a rematch. How about that?
No problem. Yeah, hey, I love it. And I'm going to say this. Mitchell Younger defeated a returning state place winner from Mechanicsburg in his first match at Marion Harding. I mean, he is so poised late in the third.
Mitchell Younger's the real deal.
Oh, he is. He's doing a great job, and he reminds me a little bit of Sammy Sasso. Oh, there's only 4 seconds left on the clock, and I've got to get a takedown to the back? Okay, I'll do it. Bam! And he does it. Type of deal.
Maddox Simcoe from Columbian, from Tiffin Columbian, he's a junior.
Yeah.
He could push Gessler, in my opinion.
His dad's a coach at Tiffin, baby.
Yeah, his dad's a head coach. Man, that's crazy. That is wild that a freshman handled Gessler like that. That is wow.
That's impressive.
I can't pick. I have a hard time. Like, I love Simcoe. I think Simcoe's crazy. He's got a goofy style.
The winner of that Wilmington district tournament, which in this case was Younger, did himself a world of favor.
Yeah, as we're away from Simcoe.
Rowan is no slouch from Perry.
Calvin Rowan, yeah.
Hey, baby. Well, I'm gonna agree with you. I think we're gonna have a rematch of the district tournament. It's gonna be Younger, Gessler. I'm gonna pick Younger. You're gonna pick Gessler, and the loser is going to owe the other one Dippin' Dots.
There you go. I got Gessler.
Deal. I got
Younger. The coaching staff's a college coaching staff. Not that Watterson's isn't. Not that Ross Thatcher doesn't know what he's doing. It's not what I'm saying. But it's just like there's so much preparation that goes into it. And the Graham way out on Saturday night, just the semifinal way out just favors them.
Yeah, I agree.
Favors them. 100% favors them. There's no question. I like it. I like it. I mean, dude, whatever. We're just two guys talking. And we can't.
Yeah, I get it.
Great. Who do you like here? Who do you like here? 150 D2. 150 D2.
150 D2. I'm conquering the – is Abinader a relation to Dominic, this Nicholas?
That's east side of Cleveland.
Yeah, hey, baby, come on now.
Has to be. I bet you that is.
They're boys. How about this line 9?
Who do you got here?
Nietenbach from Buckeye. He's a sophomore. He's a stud. He's a stud. He's going to beat Simmons from Alliance, and then he's going to beat Stout from St. Clairsville to get to the finals. He might be Cunningham from Aurora, but we'll see. I think he beats Stout, and he ends up facing – man, I can't – I want to take Byerly, but I don't know if I can.
So that's Plain City, right?
Yeah. Yep, west side of 270 there.
Yeah. I am going to go with – are you ready?
Yeah.
I like a Perry rematch. Partain is going to lose to Nick Willingham this time around. Willingham is going to get a title.
Go ahead, Willingham.
I'll go with Willingham. Got it. Hold on. Let me see. Let's see the result. I'm going to look at the result. Let's see if he can flip it.
Do it.
Perry. Let's see if he can flip it. All right. I think it's 5-1. I think Willingham flips it.
I'll say this. You got Nietenbach, Stout at the bottom.
Yeah.
Neaton Mountain's going to come out and get this. Here's my Indian Creek pick for the day, Patera, coming all the way out from the two spot there, line four. He's going to come out. He's going to – Patera is going to lose to Neatenbach in the finals.
Okay.
That's my guy.
All right.
Boom.
Neatenbach, you took the Buckeye guy.
I did. Okay. Oh, Logan Hours. This isn't even hard. Logan Hours.
Hold on. Stop.
Yeah, go for it.
Stop. Are you serious? Hold on.
Yeah.
Can't do that to me. The Mikey Kinzel dude is a monster. The Mikey Kinzel dude is an absolute monster.
He's allowed to be.
Mikey Kinzel will clear the bottom because this is 157. Logan Hours knocks off Mikey Kinzel in the finals. Agree. Couldn't agree with you more.
Hey, Logan Hours is going to have Cody Matthews in the quarters, and then he's going to have Antoine Burns in the semis. My boys from Central Ohio are bringing it in this weight class. Mm-hmm. Andrew Barkford.
Ashton Smith's pretty good from Aurora.
What's that?
Ashton Smith's pretty good from Aurora.
Oh, I know he is.
Don't so get punked. Ashton, get it. see what I did?
Yeah. Hey, you're mentioning the sales. They're up and coming. They got a freshman right here, Andrew Barkford, man. Really good kid. I mean,
he's got Mikey Kinzel first round.
I know. That's the problem.
Mikey Kinzel is massive for the weight.
Oh,
I watched him wrestle Scavuzzo from Highland, and he dominated Scavuzzo on the mat, and the ref stopped it when he was turning Scavuzzo. And Scavuzzo survived and beat him, but Kinzel was super impressive. I told you, he's the Bowling Green guy. I was telling you, he is a monster, dude.
That's a monster.
Kinzel in the finals versus Hours. Hours wins by comfortable margin. Okay.
This is it.
People keep asking me about this Dylan Newsome guy. Go off, sir. Go off.
Dylan Newsome, number one. Incredibly, how do I say this? Incredibly knowledgeable about the sport. Impressive technique-wise. Also incredibly strong. I don't know another way to say that. When you package all that together, it's going to be him and Lillard in the finals, and I can't wait to see it. Bishop Hartley has never had a state champ. I think they've had one or two state finalists. And, they've had two state finalists. I do believe this is their guy. He's 38-0. He's going to be facing Tyler Lillard. I'm glad they got separated. And it's going to be the finals match for the ages, and I can't – wait to see it happen. I hope like heck Bishop Hartley wins.
Okay. I got Lillard clearing the bottom.
Yep.
He will beat Max Ray.
He's tough.
Max Ray's tough. He was a placer last year for Bellevue at 52. Max Ray's really tough. Won the OEC a bunch of times. Him and Lillard will be a good match, but Tyler Lillard's just too much. Lillard, they have a common opponent. So I'll go Shadrick Sloan to their common opponent.
Okay.
Lillard beat Shadrick Sloan by major decision. Max Ray lost to Shadrick Sloan by, I think it wasn't close. It wasn't close. I called the match.
We call this the
Sloan scores a lot of points. I picked him for Willard to win. He's an Edison guy last year in the finals. He lost to Pummel. So I'll take Dylan Newsome, Lillard. I will take Lillard in the finals. Do you see the guy that's 5-1 from Buckeye? Badu? You see him?
Yeah, I do. Badu.
5-1?
Yeah, that's 3-3. That's two matches in his
So he's two at the sectionals and three and then he lost to the district final.
In the final, yeah. Hey, real quick, another check out line 12, freshman from DeSales. I mean,
Lincoln Shula's a stud, dude.
Oh, yeah, he is. I think
Lincoln Shula's a stud, but the only
brother Max
has. His only problem is he got
Max Ray.
If he can knock off Chaddock, and Chaddock's a senior, he's a freshman. You know, that's hard to do.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I like Shula. Lincoln Shula is a stud. Did they have that spelled wrong?
No.
Is that right? Is that how they spell Lincoln?
Oh, they don't have an L. No, there should be an L in there, second L, I think.
Okay. But I like Lillard at the weight.
Yeah, me too. And I like him to meet up with Newsom, and I like Newsom as the champ. 175. All right.
75 blood
killer
bath. Are you ready for this one?
It's incredible.
Zach Burrows. Okay. Zach Burrows is going to take on Brady Welch in the semifinals.
Yes.
blood bath.
I cannot believe this.
Listen, Brady Welch is going to App State. He's a stud, right? He's pushed Brody Conley. They've had a 1-point match. They look at the, here. I'm going to tell you what they were the sectional. Brody beat him 3-0 in the sectional final. Let me see what the district was. I'm going to have to go off on a Brody Conley rant here. Sorry, it's been brewing.
I love it. All right, he's stud.
Total freak, right? Number one guy in the country, best guy in the country. He beat him 3-1. He beat Welch 3-1 in the district final. Beat him 3-0 in the sectional final. Beat him 3-2 at this Ashland tournament. Ready? Got it? You with me?
Yep.
So I have Brady Welch clearing Zach Burrows. He's going to clear Zach Burrows on that top.
Fair enough.
Brody Conley, Noah Peterson. He's going to have to clear Noah Peterson.
Yeah.
I don't know enough about Froelich or Kaiser or any of those guys. The
quarter
record
doesn't
matter for Brody Conley. But Brody Conley bumped up to 215 at the SBC, so that's going to be a conference. In the semifinals, he's wrestling the Oak Harbor guy. The Oak Harbor guy gets to the getting a funky position. I have it on video. It's on the Ohio cast. Go check it out. He tweaks Conley's knee. Conley takes injury time. They get him 2 knee braces. He puts them on. And is like limping around, but he's still so light and athletic on his feet. And he just pins the Oak Harbor guy, who's a dude. He's 40 pounds smaller than this guy.
Yeah.
And in the finals, he knocked off Straub of Bellevue and dominated Straub, who tried to kind of big brother him. You know, is what they should have done.
Yeah.
Bellevue had pretty good coaching there. But Brody Conley, best guy in the country, in my opinion. Brody Conley, going to be a multiple time NCAA All-American at West Virginia for Tim Flynn. Brody Conley, just a complete freak mutant, total package, 174. He may get big enough for 84. He's so athletic, dude, All-State in football. Brody Conley and Welch is going to be a bloodbath then again in the finals because, as you know, it's really hard to beat someone 4 times in a year.
Yes. And, you know, interesting note, Brady Welch bumped up to 190, wrestled junior champ or junior finalist out of Fargo, Caden McDaniel, and was able to defeat him.
Wait, Caden McDaniel?
Yeah.
McDaniel? Is that who beat Shoemate?
Shoemate, yeah, just this weekend.
Oh, my God.
You don't tell me that Welch kid is the real deal, man.
Dude, how about we got two weights back-to-back in D2? Number one, two best guys in the country in Ohio, D2.
Yeah.
Right? It's crazy. Does. So listen, I'm going to take Conley cautiously over Welch 5-4.
I'm down with it. I actually like that pick. I'm the same way. I love that. I love the 1.5-point spread, and I'm taking the under.
Yeah. I got Conley by a point, but, man, could Welch knock him off? Sure, I just don't see it. You know what I mean? Maybe Welch makes me eat my words. I don't know. But Brody Conley's hard to pick
again. You know who's not
going
to make
so you? Did Conley beat – your guy, he beat the dude from Hartley in the finals. Is that right?
Yes, that is absolutely correct. And I think, and I don't know. It could be Newsom was at 75 for a lot of the year. Maybe his plan all along was to go down to 65. But I think after seeing, hey, Conley's at 75, I'll just go 65. And now I've got Lillard instead of having Conley, Welch, and maybe even Burrows. So you've got 3 up there. You've got Lillard and you've got Ray, but now Ray's on the other side. So yeah, man, there you go.
I like his path. Though. I like Dylan Newsom's path.
So he
had a close match with Conley last year in state finals, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He did.
5-3, right?
At Highland.
Yeah. Sparta Highland, right?
Not Sparta. You're right.
We're going to be out of the weeds real quick here at 190 because there's not much weeds to get
into. I'm calling
into.
Dylan Fish back before you do.
Yeah, well, you got me. Let's go. But hold on. Wait. Hold on. Stop. This is a dude, another Iron Man placer in there. Hold on. We gotta calm down here. Blake Schaefer is really tough, an Iron Man placer, knocked off some nationally ranked guys. So we can't sleep on this Schaefer guy. And I gotta look real quick. Hold on. I gotta see what their district final score was. So just bear with me because that will give us a greater indication. And as we know, Fishbeck scores a ton of points, right?
Yeah, hey, while you're looking that up, this is all I can say. Blake Schaefer.
14-1.
Yo, what's that?
14-1.
There you go. Well, Blake Schaefer is going to have to get to the semis, and he'll have Austin Starr from Indian Creek there. That kid's a hammer, dude. That's going to be your semifinal. They're going to beat each other up. Whoever emerges the winner is going to have Dylan Fishback, who's – I'm not going to say that he's going to walk, but he's probably going to win pretty good. You know, he's not going to be challenged like Starr, Schaefer in the semis. They're going to beat each other up in that way. So Fishback's going to show up healthy, ready to go, and bam. He's gonna put it on somebody.
Even 14-1 again. Even if he's hurt, he wins.
Yeah, I agree.
He beat the Iron Man, he won.
Yeah.
Beat Chandler, or he beat Rogers, right? He beat Rylan Rogers, not Chandler. Chandler's his cousin. Rylan Rogers, you know, was Rylan Rogers really good, man. Prep national champ, 2-time Idaho State champ, prep national champ for Blair as a sophomore, Iron Man champ as a sophomore. You can't say enough about that matchup too. It's one of the best Iron Man finals ever. On a postage stamp, Matt. I just don't get it. But anyhow, I won't go off. But 215, gonna be a bloodbath war. I love it.
Rematch of an Iron Man match. We're going to have Neves. We're going to have Snyder. We're going to have Max Schulaw. We're going to have Snyder, Max Schulaw in the semis at the bottom. You're going to have Neves.
Are you kidding me? That's a semi?
Oh, yeah, it's a
oh my God! Hold on, Snyder's the defending champ.
I know he's gonna have Schulaw in the finals. Hey, Caden Haynes,
that's your quarter bracket draw.
Yeah,
you won a district title, man. Come on.
No, Schulaw will be in the top in that third quarter.
He's in the bottom. Yeah, but he's in the bottom. Yeah. But the guy, this Caden Haynes guy, won his district and he got gifted with Max Schulaw in his quarter final.
Followed by Snyder. Like,
okay.
Hey, great job winning your district. Here's Shula and here's Kyle Snyder. And then you get to the finals, and that's when you're going to wrestle old Carter Neves.
Yeah. So Carter Neves clears the top.
Yeah.
Straub, see the Bellevue guy, Straub?
Yeah.
Straub is the guy that Brody Conley beat in the SBC finals when he was hurt with a hurt knee down 40 pounds.
Yeah.
So that speaks once again to, obviously, Brody Conley.
Yes.
I don't even have a top quarter guess there. I'll go with Carter Neves clears and somebody in the top quarter, and then I will take Shula over Snyder.
I love it.
I will take Shula over Snyder, and I will take Shula over Neves.
State champ sophomore. Let's rock and roll.
What do you think? Well, dude, they're both sophomores.
Oh, I know. My thing is Max Schulaw has been known to get a little loose in a match. Like, he might try to Granby roll when he shouldn't. He might try to roll across his back when he shouldn't. He might try to do something that he shouldn't. It's happened a couple times. If they've changed, now that was in Iron Man, I saw him do it. If they've changed, if they've tightened up the reins a little bit, if he's not doing those things, I think he clears, and I think he's in the match. I mean, he's on the stage on Sunday night. Period.
The only guy Fishback didn't bonus point last year in the whole state series.
Incredible stuff. So
like he's strong or something. He struggled with the size because Shulaw's massive.
Yeah. Yeah, he is.
Shulaw's massive. So I'm going to go Shulaw over Neves, but I don't know. Neves can win, man. That's a 50-50.
No, that's a 50-50. That's a total 50
because they split, right? They split the Iron Man and in the district. They split.
Yep. Sure is.
Snyder's hard. I mean, it's, you know, no disrespect to Kyle Snyder. I just don't know if he can deal with the physicality of Max Schulaw.
Certainly.
No?
Well, I like it. Hey, real quick, you mentioned Neves clearing the top. He's going to have to beat Getz, by the way. He'll have to beat Getz in the semis. Neves will come out. Schulaw will come out. Toss-up match. Who shows up that night? You take your pick. I'll pick Max Schulaw because, well, I'm a Central Ohio homer, and that's just the way it's going
to be. You know what? You can have Schulaw. I picked Schulaw initially. But I'm thinking more about the Neves thing, and Neves won the last one. It's just
fair enough.
The level of coaching between these programs is just so high.
I agree.
It's just like you're saying, he's got to tighten it up. You can't get all wild, and you can't do that against a Graham guy. Graham guys are so solid.
Yeah, I agree.
Solid's the middle name. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, let's see. Carter Solid Neves, right? They're just solid. They're so solid. They rarely lose their position. They're not going to reach. They're not going to take an ill-advised roll or reach back. Yes. They're just not doing that.
Right on.
All right.
Hey, the match at 285, the match of the day.
Hold on. Let's go Shula. I'll go Shula. Heck with it.
Heck yeah, we will. Hey, let's talk 285. Quarterfinal, top quarterfinal. Matt TBA, 613. Thad Huff versus Todd Allen. I'm telling you, that is a semifinal slash fight. If it wasn't for Nolan.
The returning champ from Medina Buck.
That's fine. I like Huff.
My dude, I'm taking Todd Allen.
Oh, you can. You can all you want.
Yeah.
He's going to get beat by Nolan Neves. Is that what you're going to say?
I'm taking Todd Allen.
You're allowed to.
Todd Allen is going to clear the top half.
Listen, Todd Allen's going to have to beat Thad Huff, and he's going to have to beat Gage Sampson. That's two back-to-back matches just to get to Nolan Neves.
Okay, so listen. I'll take Todd Allen into the finals, and then I will take Nolan Neves to win the state title.
I have zero issue with that. I really don't have an issue with that.
There's my pick. That's all I got for you. Yeah. Can we move on to D1?
Yes, sir.
All right. You're a maniac. You know that? We're going to end up being in 2 hours, you freak. I'm grabbing these other brackets.
Grab them, baby.
All right. Oh, that's not what I wanted. So D1, 106, very competitive. Talk to me. Who you got? Who you like?
Well, Zeb, here's the deal. Division one is probably a little harder. You mentioned less parity in Division two. I think Division one is a little harder to pick.
Real hard. Very difficult.
I've been watching this cat at the bottom line there, Gunnar Havens. I'm telling you, this kid is an absolute terror. Not to give away any secrets, he is a terror on top. He is a Logan Stever type of guy. If he gets on top, he is going to turn you. I guarantee it.
You know his only problem? Do you know his only problem is?
Brett Stanley?
Adam Butler.
Adam Butler. Gotcha.
Adam Butler. Brett Stanley's massive for the weight, by the way. The backup from St. Edward's beat Stanley in the duel. Is that right? Hold on. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. The backup. The backup. Timar is the backup to Butler. Timar is the backup to Butler. The backup to Adam Butler beat Brett Stanley at Brecksville in the dual meet.
That's insane.
And then they got two other guys. They're so loaded, dude.
St. Ed's is built for the state tournament.
They are. But this one's easy for me. I'm taking Cole Evans, clears the top. I'm going to take Cole Evans, Gunnar Havens. Cole Evans wins the match, wins the state title.
I'm calling Gunnar Havens in the finals champion.
You're taking him over who?
I'll take him over Cole Evans. I don't have a problem with that.
All right, Cole Evans, D1, 106-pound Division I champ. Zeb's pick. Your pick is Gunnar Havens.
Gunnar Havens.
Asheville, Taze Valley, correct?
Get some, yep.
All right, 113, Blazer by a million. Blazer by a million. Blazer by Mortal Kombat, finish him. Blazer by, there's nobody within five points of him here.
I love this semifinal, though, because Jackson Roselli is my boy. That kid is the man.
Yeah.
But Blaze is Blaze, so.
I am going to take Grunzweig. Grunzweig from Solon, where my wife teaches. I'm going to take Grunzweig is going to run into young baby Blazer, Marcus Blazer, best guy in the country, Iron Man champ. Ice in his veins. I'll take that all day, twice on Sunday, whatever you need. Marcus Blazer, we don't even need to get in the weeds there. Let's go to 120.
120 it
wait,
is.
Wait. Did you hear what I just picked?
Yeah, you picked Blazernator.
Hold on. Who did I pick at 106?
Ooh,
Cole. I picked Evans. Perrysburg guy. I picked two Perrysburg. So Perrysburg twice. Right out of the gate can win two weights. Are they going to be able to outweigh? Because we already know who's going to win D3 and D2, right? We know that. We know Legacy's too loaded, right? We know that D2's Graham, right? We know that.
Yep.
So now if you have Evans comes out and wins and you have Blazer come out and win, now wait until you hear my pick here at 120.
Josh Niemann.
Josh, well, you're not picking. You can seriously, I don't want to do that to you, okay? Are you ready?
Yeah.
I am going to have on the bottom half clearing I'm going to have, dude, you got a state champ down on the bottom, Peyton Fenton.
11-12. Line 11-12. Yes. Look at that.
Josh has got Damian Ryan of Centerville. I saw Damian Ryan at, I called the match between Damian Ryan and the Lima Central Catholic dude. Ah, jeez.
I know the answer to that. Yeah, why don't.
What's LCC guy's name? Come on, help me out.
It's getting late. Getting late.
No, there's a bunch of them. Come on.
No. They have a kid who's like tops. He's a stud.
Yeah. Lima Central Catholic dude is why am I drawing a blank? The brother wrestles for one's at Navy. One's at Caprala.
Ah, thank you.
Caprala. Caprala and Damian Ryan had a barn burner of a match, had a great match at Pitt. So nice. Your kid's actually in a good spot there. All right.
Daggone right he is.
So here we go. You ready? Here's my pick. Yeah. Yet another finalist. I take Ryan Avalos over Nick Molchek.
Got Austin it.
McBurney's right there too, man. Maslin Perry guy. Maslin Perry guy. You got to watch that. Ryan Avalos isn't ready. He's gonna get knocked off by McBurney. He better be ready. So listen, this guy can go from winning or being in the finals to losing first round to McBurney.
Yes.
That's a tough draw for Perrysburg there.
Yes, agreed. They do this week.
But here's what I'm gonna tell you. Avalos knocked off Fenton he beat him in the Maumee Bay Classic final. Because I'm gonna take a rematch. I'm gonna take Avalos, who won the district. He's beaten Fenton the last two times they've wrestled. You hearing me?
I'm hearing you.
I am going to pick Peyton Fenton to win a state title. He's going to go bookends, win a state title. He's going to knock off Avalos, but Avalos getting in the state final is going to be huge and enough for Perrysburg to be up there in the team score. But I just don't think the depth of Eds is just too much, dude.
Oh, my gosh.
So I'm going to really go Peyton Jackson Fenton's going to clear the bottom. I mean, listen, I'm not trying to rip your heart out or stomp on your guts, dude. I'm not trying
to do that. You're not doing anything.
I'm not trying to do that. You know that. So we're going to have you abstain. I'm going to take Peyton Fenton off the bottom, and we will have Ryan Avalos on the top runner-up. Okay.
What do you know about Molchek from Solon?
Molchek. Scrambly. Wait, it's either Molchek. It's real scrambly. One of them's real. Grunzweig or Molchek. Someone's super scrambly. Because okay. My wife's like, hey, Solon's wrestling, because she teaches her. She'll be like, look. And then she said, I can't keep all the names straight, to be honest with you.
No problem.
Molchek's pretty tough.
Yes.
Very tough. All the Solon's has always got tough guys. They're solid. I mean, Jackson Joy, Peyton Fenton. That's a first round match.
Please, someone get the rest of that.
Oh, my God.
Hey, we get that thing uploaded by the time 132 steps on the mat. You'll have 500 views in a minute.
Jackson Joy, Peyton Fenton. I mean, listen, it could be Jackson Joy out of the bottom win the state title.
100%. I agree.
Holy good. But I like Avalos, man. I like Avalos. McBurney could clear the top. Molchek could clear the top. I mean, this is a great weight. 38's a great weight in D1, too. So
yes.
But I'm going to stick with it. I mean, it could be Jackson Joy, but let's stick with Peyton Fenton. I think he's due. Maybe he's got some magic left. He was state champ as a freshman. Let's go with Peyton Fenton winning the weight. I'm gonna ask you to abstain, okay?
Deal. Let's go 126. Right.
26. Amar, geez, oh, Pete.
Hey.
Caden Jett. That's a good one.
Yeah.
Geez, oh, Pete. Obviously, Ayub coming out against a Maslin Perry guy, that's never a good draw. Ryan Bennett. I like Ryan Bennett. He's a state champ last year. I like Acuna. Brew. I like Brew from Wadsworth. Wow, this is a good weight. Vinny D'Alessandro, big fan. Wow, this is a good weight. 126-13.
Was Bennett 6 or 13?
Say it again.
Was Bennett 6 or 13?
6. Last year? He won last year at 6.
Man,
Jett was third. So Caden Jett of Brecksville was third at 20 last year.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to take Caden Jett to clear Ayub. Ayub's tough, though, dude. Did Omar not wrestle at Ironman? Omar Ayub?
I think he did. I think he might have had a bad tournament.
No, because he's only got one loss.
You're right. He might not have wrestled.
I like that semi though. That Caden Jett Ayoub semi is going to be a war.
Hey man, Ayoub, he really impressed me. I didn't think he was going to be able to withstand Brennan Cernas, his strength and his speed.
Yeah,
he was able to do it. He's real funky. He's long and wiry, and he's grippy. He's grippy.
Grippy.
Yeah, and he ended up coming out on top a late scramble and in his favor. And I'm sure Cernas is 100% now, but just tweaked himself a little bit in the scramble, trying to hold on a little long. But he did not do himself any favors by getting third. So
yeah, let's just talk about that.
I mean, dude, that whole bottom section.
You got Acuna on the bottom.
Yes.
You got Brennan Cernas. You got Brew. Yes. You got Billy D'Alessandro, and then you got Bennett. Literally, any of those guys named I just said could make the final.
Right on.
There's legit. I don't know Nathan Perry. You know, nothing against him. I don't know Spurgeon. Nothing against him. But I don't know Eli Marengo. He's 19 and 13. But five of those dudes can make the finals.
Incredible. And Spurgeon was a placer last year. I think he got seventh last year. I mean, he's a full 26 pounder. That's the biggest thing.
Is this Cernas' first year at Pickerington Central?
It is. He was Indiana State champ at Culver Academy. His freshman moved out to Wyoming Seminary for 2 years and then came back. His dad's a Pickerington Central guy.
So how did he do at preps his sophomore year?
Man, that's a great question. You know, I'm not really sure. I'm sure he did well. I mean, he's freaking good, man. He is good.
Dude, that is a really good weight class.
Oh, I know.
Caden Jett, Amari Ubes at the top. I mean, it's
the semifinal is lights out.
Listen, here's what I got. You ready? I'm going to take Ryan Bennett to clear the bottom.
Deal.
And then I'm going to take – you're not going to like this. I'm going to take Caden Jett to clear the top.
I'm going Ayoub versus Acuna.
Ayoub and Acuna? Okay. Yep. I like Bennett.
Okay, fine.
Bennett, Jett. Jett knocked him off in the dual meet. I'll take Jett. Brexville gets the first state champ. Ed's got their first finalist, and Ed's going to have a bunch, as you're going to hear about to hear.
I can't wait.
It's about to start rolling here. You ready?
32.
132, Division I, 2022. Nick Jerome's super funky from Solon. He's super funky.
Really?
Yeah, he's super funky. Yes.
Back to back to back right there for them.
Yeah, so I am going to go with that the Allenson Denkins, Nick Jerome.
Oh, it's gonna be a first play. Round match.
Ty Wilson's defending state champ, right?
Yeah, he's coming up from 113. And I'm gonna tell you what, I think he honestly is cutting to get to 32. My boy is jacked, strong as an ox, never gets out of position, can roll with anyone. I'm telling you, Ty Wilson is the real deal.
I have a hard time, you know, picking against defending state champs, depending on their body of work.
It's difficult.
It's really hard to do. But I'm going to take Ty Wilson to clear that top.
Me too.
He'll be the winner of Jerome Denkins. And they really need that. Like, Allenson Denkins is going to be a huge part of Perrysburg, whether they get a trophy or not.
Yes.
They need him in the placement. They need Allenson Denkins in the placement.
Gotta make
Could he go on a run? Sure. Is he going to beat Ty Wilson? I don't think so.
Gotcha.
So I'll take Ty Wilson to clear the top. And then I like Jeremy Ginter on the bottom of Whitmer to clear the bottom. He is.
I thought the same.
He's a rattlesnake. Woo, he's mean. I like him. I like Ginter, but I'll take Wilson in the finals. Ginter, your runner up.
I agree.
Okay. 38, one of your better weights. Deep, super deep weight. Super deep weight. I will take Niffenegger to clear the top. He beats Bradley Eaton in the semis. Eaton's a big part of what's going to be happening at St. Edward's. Really good. So I'll take Jake Niffenegger of LaSalle to clear. He's in the finals again. I think he's a two-time finalist. Missed the COVID year. Finalist as a freshman. Yeah. And then finalist last year lost to Joey Blaze. On the bottom, Ishmael Ayoub, Nate Burnett.
Insane quarter.
Davari Van Dyke, which is Boots, if you don't know.
Yes.
Davari Van Dyke, his name is Boots.
Yep.
Oh, man. Ishmael and Ayoub, Boots, I don't know. I mean, could Nate Burnett knock off Ayoub? Yeah. So no. I'm going to pick Burnett. Burnett lost to Van Dyke last year at State. Burnett gets healthy. He defaulted to Eaton in the semifinals of the district, came back and took third. So I will take Niffenegger into the finals versus Nate Burnett to clear bottom.
I got AU clearing the bottom, and here's why. His graph goes like this. He starts off slow, and just by the time the third period, he's hitting on all cylinders. He is ready. I mean, he will – like, he's up 2-0 in the first – into the first, 5-0 into the second. He's tech-falling you at the end. I'm telling you, the kid is just that way. It's We're going to go AU. Right?
Jump around Wisconsin?
Yeah, he's going to Wisconsin. That's right. AU was Niffenegger. I got AU in the finals.
Okay. I got Nate Burnett over Niffenegger in the finals.
Noted. 44. Let's talk.
44. Blazer next.
Blazer all. Hey, man, Ethan Burden's the real deal. Be ready. He is long, lanky, and quick.
They've wrestled a couple times.
What's that?
1 point wins by Blazer.
Gotcha. Well, it's time to turn the tide. I'm glad they're on the opposite sides.
I'll take Blazer over Burden. What do you got?
I'll take Burden over Blazer.
All right. Joey Blaze is my guy.
All right, I did.
So, wait. I've got – think about it. I got 6-20, 6-13, 20, all finalists. Four finalists I've picked for Perrysburg now.
And now 44. Yeah.
Yeah, ready?
That's impressive. And two, I think, for St. Ed's.
50. You ready?
Where is
– Connor – wait. This is 50, isn't it? Yeah. I skipped 50. Sorry.
You're good.
All right. I have at 150 a rematch. I already got my final pick. You ready?
Yeah.
My rematch is Winton Denkins versus Chris Ernest that went the distance, the full rideouts, everything, won by a rideout by Denkins.
Denkins has Smith in the quarters, coach.
I hear your words.
I know. I'm just saying.
I hear your words, but I'm taking Winton Denkins into the finals. He clears the bottom. Chris Ernest will clear the top, and it is going to be – I tell you what, these Miller kids. See the Millers? There's these
twins. Yeah, Tyler Miller from St. Ed's quarters.
Yeah. Oh, man, they're really good. Ty Miller could absolutely beat Chris Ernest. But I think Chris Ernest is going to be ready to go. That guy's a freshman. Ty Miller, Winton Denkins is you want to see that, trust me.
Hey,
I'm going to take the junior Ernest to clear him and Denkins in the finals, and it's going to be another just Donnybrook because they've split this year.
Yeah, right.
So that's going to be
finalists for Perrysburg, by the way. Five. If Miller can win over Ernest, he can clear the top and get into the finals.
Yes. That's huge for St. Ed's. They're going to need something. They'll need something like that. They'll get something like that, though.
Yeah, go on.
They're just so strong up top, too. So I'm going to take Denkins over Ernest. Overtime. Double leg in overtime.
Overtime. He said overtime. I like Denkins. I'm going to Ernest. I'm putting Dinkins in. That's five, coach. That's five finalists for your boys, Perrysburg.
Yeah, they might. They're going to be right there in the hunt. I don't know if they just don't have the firepower, the high end firepower.
Gotcha.
Coming up in the higher upper weights that you're going to about.
Right. Okay. Now we start the transition.
Yeah. So this one's easy for me. I'll take Connor Uten into the finals. There's a banger first round matchup between Jay Miller and A.J. Dolph.
Ooh, Dolphinator. Heck
yes. Yeah.
Freshman. That's
a great dude. Look out for that one. I think that Noah Ewan will run into Uten, which is going to be huge for points for Perrysburg here. And I think Jay Miller, him and Dolph's going to be – that's a great first-round matchup.
That's huge for St. Ed's, and I would take St. Ed's in this matchup just because it's St. Ed's. They are so good at the state tournament, man.
Yes,
they are so good. So
let's go Miller into the semis versus Scavuzzo. Who you got?
Yes, and I take Scavuzzo in that.
Scavuzzo beat that jacked freak from Gibsonburg, Smith, Connor Smith.
Boom.
But they split the week before. Smith beat him. the next week Scavuzzo beat him.
Because they made adjustments because the old man Scavuzzo knows what he's doing.
Yeah, Jimmy Scavuzzo knows where the bear does its business in the woods. Okay? I will take Iowa State. James Scavuzzo into the final there. I don't know, man. Jay Miller could have it. He could make it, though. He could knock off Scavuzzo, but I think they're game. I think they're ready. So I got Uton winning the weight, though.
You're doggone right you do, because he's going to Iowa State. And he's a hammer.
Connor Uton's a stud, dude. Connor Uton's the real deal. Connor Uton was at the sectional I was at.
And I said, hey, are you going to let David Carr know that you just won your sectional? And he goes, he doesn't care about a sectional title. I said, okay, if you say so. Oh, man. He doesn't care about a sectional title, by the way.
Yeah. All right. David Carr's on a
50-match winning streak. 165
Division I 2022. I am going to go with – I've seen this Alasco guy from Nordonia. I liked him.
Okay.
But I really like Evan Bennett to clear into that semi.
Yeah, against Des Gartrell.
Des Gartrell is for real and fun to watch.
He is – he's explosive, dynamic, quick, and he – and I tell you what, he's got some movement, left-to-right lateral movement that if you're not ready for, he's going to get behind you real quick. Be ready.
This is where it makes or breaks Perrysburg. This is where the rubber meets the road if you're Perrysburg. You ready?
I think you can get to the semis.
I will take – this is where Eds is going to get him. Ready? I take Evan Bennett over Gartrell. I'll take Evan Bennett into the finals over Gartrell.
Okay.
And this is where if Tackett's can clear that bottom, he's got a favorable bottom draw. He didn't get Gartrell on his half. He didn't get Bennett in his half. He obviously beat Bennett in the finals. But if Miles Tackett's clears.
Yeah.
They're right there, dude. But what you're going to find out is it's about to start rolling for St. Ed's because both Miller brothers are going to place. Bradley Eaton's going to place. You know, obviously, younger Bennett's going to place, the returning champ. Yep. I mean, you're just going to have a – I mean, St. Ed's just got – the numbers are just too much because Perrysburg's only got 9. Ed's got, I think, 12.
So I'll go
Evan Bennett clears the top. He takes on – Tackett's. I'll take Tackett's into the finals, but then I'll take Evan Bennett to win the weight.
And hey, why does Bennett only have 22 matches?
Who's that?
Evan Bennett. He has 22 matches.
I'm not sure.
I don't know either, but I'm gonna.
I know they had a lot of football guys. I don't know if he's a football guy though. Hold on, let me tell you. Let me tell you what their district final was. Tackett's.
I'd love to know that.
Versus Bennett. Ready?
Yep.
Dinkins beat Smaller Miller 6-3 in the finals. Trinsky Valeria forfeited at 57. 65. Tackett's beat Bennett 1-0. I feel even better about my pick now.
Hey, I've got one for you. This is a sleeper. Jacob Hurley out of Westland.
Yeah.
My boy is going to make the semis. If it's a stylistic matchup that favors Hurley, he is a grinder. He's ready to go 15 minutes a match. The guy has a gas tank from hell. It's not favorable.
Have you been looking at Perrysburg's draws?
Yes.
They got really good draws.
I know. Well, Tackett's he's got to win for his team here. He's got to get to the finals. Huge points if he can win the semifinals.
I'll take Tackett's to the finals, though. Dude, what's that put him at 6 finalists?
Yeah, it does, by the way. And I think St. Ed's is at 4.
Yeah, St. Ed's is at 4. They're at 6. For me, my picks. Okay.
I got you. I'm getting Hurley in there, by the way.
All right. 175. This one's academic for me. This is very easy.
Oh, my Ohio State commit, Luke Geog.
Geog? Like geography is actually how you say it. He let me know. I'll take this. This one, I like this one. I like this. First off, this Ohoro guy is pretty tough from Boardman. He's 43.
Semifinal is going to be huge.
Yeah, he's tough, but Vanadia beat him. Geog beat Vanadia via tech fall at the state duels. Geog is the class of this weight. I'm going to take Mitchell Broski versus Luke Geog in the finals. Geog by major decision.
Could see. I will say this about Mitchell Broski. He has a knack to end up on top oh, you have a single leg in the air, all of a sudden you're on your back. That's all.
Can I give you Geog's district? Can I give you his four district match results? Are you ready?
38 seconds, 54 seconds, 15-0.
15-second pin, 23-second pin, 35-second pin. 2 minutes and 18 seconds in the finals.
Oh, my gosh.
Geog is going to be problems. He is the reason that Perrysburg won't win the state title.
Wow.
His points will be the difference. I guarantee you when you look at it at the end of the day, like say St. Ed's has a subpar tournament or just an average tournament.
Yeah.
Geog smashing everybody, his placement, his pins, is everybody's going to max out. It's like having Logan Stieber on your team.
Right.
He's going to bonus everybody. He's going to pin everybody.
Yeah.
Make your decision, Broski.
He is two Brodsky's for the win.
He's a Kent Stater, so I like that. I like him.
Yeah, I know you're golden flash, baby.
Yeah, so I'll take him in the finals. He loses to – it's not going to be close with Geog. Geog's jumped levels. He looks good.
I got you.
The Iron Man looked pretty good. Oh, man. Oh, man. This one coming up, though.
190 pounds, Division One, Ohio State Wrestling Tournament, 2022.
St. Edward's got a terrible draw here. They got a terrible draw here.
Terrible. You're gonna have.
I mean, we already know. Let's cut through all of it. We got McDaniel is gonna hit Shoemate in the finals. Let's just get that out of the way. Johnny Slaper is a state placer last year at like 220 as a freshman. He's down to 90 for St. Ed's. He's not beating McDaniel in the semifinals. It's not happening.
Not happening.
So I'm gonna take South Shoemate via pin, whatever. Man, Wadsworth got screwed on this one too. Oh my God, Cohen Grimm! Hey, you won your district. You got such Shoemate in your quarters.
Shoemate in the quarters. Hey, and honestly, if the McDaniel Shoemate match is anything like the district finals, I'm telling you, every eyeball was on that match. I felt proud to be Central District at that point because I felt that the crowd. Now, this is just my experience. I felt that the crowd knew it was at hand. Two top-level wrestlers giving it everything they had for 6 minutes, and then it went into overtime. Well, sudden victory. And then they got an extra bonus, 40 seconds? And McDaniel actually got in on the shot first, gets the takedown. I'm telling you, it was remarkable, man. It was a phenomenal match, and everybody was on their feet. It was just great. It was a great match. And if we get that on Sunday night, it's worth the price of admission. It is a phenomenal 6-minute match.
You won't even need your seat. You'll just need the edge of it.
Yeah. That's absolutely correct.
So I got to note something here. I think Johnny Slaper takes third. I think Johnny Slaper takes third. I think the Miller brothers are top three guys. I think that is how St. Edward wins this. I think that Perrysburg's going to put a bunch of guys in the finals.
Yes.
But I think that the Johnny Slaper taking third, the Miller brothers place in top two or three.
Yeah.
I think Bradley Eaton's top three. I think those are what wins the state title for St. Edward. Just a numbers game.
Yeah, hey, when you lose in the quarters, you just have to win one more to place, but they don't win one more. They win two and three, and they get into that third place.
Exactly.
Which they're racking up points. And if they get the pins in the bottom – they're getting 2 points for the pin, one for the win. They're getting 3 points.
Yes.
Instead of just one.
Yes. I'll take – oh, man, you're pushing me pretty hard.
Don't you draw on me.
You're pushing me to the limit, buddy. I'll take McDaniel clears top. He beats Slaper in the semis.
Like it.
Shoemate clears the bottom.
Yep.
He beats – jeez, oh, Pete. He beats the – jeez, oh, Pete. I don't even know there. Let's say he beats the little Miami guy in the semis.
Sure.
Pins him. Shoemate wins, knocks off McDaniel.
Hey, I can see it because Shoemate, man, his eyes were open last week. He's a gamer too. He's a 3-time state champ with the COVID in there. Or he's a 2-time state champ with the COVID in there. Excuse me. Going for his third title. I think he's ready to rock and roll. I think he's going to be laser-like focused this practice, these practices leading up. And I think it's going to be a difference maker. I really do. But McDaniel's no slouch, so be ready.
All right, here we go. 215. 2022 Division One Ohio.
Let's talk.
I'm taking the Hall of Famer.
How can you not?
I'm taking the Hall of Famer Ty Cobb on the top.
I like it. Hey, do you know who he lost to at the Kevin Cleveland Memorial on January 8th?
No, tell me.
Matthew Howard, Dublin.
How close?
Overtime.
I will take the Hall of Famer Ty Cobb in the state finals.
I want you to do that. You know why? Because I'm going to take Matthew Howard. There's one thing I know about Adam Huddle coach teams. They come ready to rock and roll when it matters. Darren Pullen is winning in the JUCO. He was a state place winner for them three years ago. And now he's at the JUCO level getting recruited by another school, like looking to go D2, D3, D1. I don't know. He's going to Edinburgh. He's going to Edinburgh, I do believe. Or Clarion. Maybe it's Clarion.
Okay.
But anywho, I got Matthew Howard clearing the
Who's
top.
Who's clearing the bottom? I'm going to take Logan Shepherd.
I'm taking Dylan Russo. Dylan Russo versus Logan
defending
Shepherd.
Defending champ. I will take Logan Shepherd, Ironman placer. Logan Shepherd, was he the Iron? He was Ironman finalist.
I think he was a finalist. He was. Yeah, I think he lost to Howard.
Shepherd.
He lost to
Howard. I think Logan Shepherd over Ty Cobb in the state finals is my pick. I know you're going to take Russo though.
I am. I'm going to take Russo Howard for a rematch, baby. Let's go.
All right. So I got, that's a district, central district
rematch.
Okay. I'll take Logan Shepherd over Ty Cobb at 215 pounds in Division One for the state title. Heavyweight. Oh, man. I think we got some future NFL guys here.
Yes.
We got Fockler. Fockler's a stud.
He is, but the problem is he's got Padilla in the semis.
Yeah, Josh Padilla is really good.
Oh, yeah, he is.
Kilbane is a problem there, though. Kilbane got beat by Ethan Green. I think Ethan Green and Michael Kilbane are future NFL guys. I'm calling it right now.
That's legit.
They're both seniors. Hold on. Green committed somewhere. He's a Big Ten football guy. Hold on. I want to get Ethan Green. Ethan Green's commitment. He's like a Big Ten guy. He's a Big Ten guy. Hold on. Ready?
Yeah. I would love to know where they're coming in. As you look this up, I'm going to tell a story about a guy who was getting recruited by Bowling Green. He was really good in football. He showed up to Bowling Green, and their MAC, they were playing a Big Ten team in one of those off-conference games. He said the levels that Big Ten is from the MAC, he says, I'm not Big Ten. I'm barely MAC. Those guys are for real. So when you say Ethan Green is a football player, Big Ten, that cat has got to have it.
Ethan Green is 6'7", 270 pounds. They already have his bio on the Cincinnati Bearcat website.
Oh, my gosh. Cincinnati Bearcats. Let's go Luke Fickell, baby. You know he loves his wrestlers.
Hold on. It says multi-sport athlete who has also stood out in wrestling, where he had a 37 record and finished third at the Ohio Division I stage. Okay, yeah, he was third last year. And they got his signing on here. So he is going to Cincinnati. Kilbane's a junior. They won the big division. I know he's got offers from a lot of the Big Tens. So, hold on, ready? I'm going to tell you Kilbane's offers.
I can only imagine.
Tell you, Michael Kilbane's offers. You ready?
Indiana, Iowa, Ohio State.
Kilbane versus Padilla is that's a great matchup. All right, so these guys, we're looking at two NFLers right here, right? Kilbane. Let me tell you his offers. You ready? Kilbane's offers are, he's a 6'4", 240-pound defensive end linebacker, first team all district, 4.25 GPA. Him and Padilla are going to hit, dude. It's going to be crazy.
In the quarter.
Minnesota, ready? He's got offers from Minnesota. All right, Minnesota's offered. Princeton. Boy, that's Wyatt Gideon. That's not him. Hold on. Let me make sure that's him. Yeah, Kilbane's got a Minnesota offer. He's got his buddies. He's putting his buddy stuff on here, too.
Okay, got you.
That pumps me up. I'm just looking here. I'm looking. Kilbane. Kentucky. So, SEC.
Yeah, baby.
Whoever Wyatt Gideon is, that's his buddy. Kilbane, Northwestern. Kilbane, Akron. Kilbane, Purdue. Indiana. Kilbane, West Virginia. Western Michigan. Oh, my God. This dude's a real deal, man. Iowa State. Tech. Virginia Tech. Vandy. Wake Forest. So he's ACC, Big 12, Big 10, MAC.
Got them all.
Not the Pac. I haven't seen anything from the Pac yet. Pac,
but that's a long way away.
Yeah, Northwestern.
Yeah.
So this is junior, though. Like, this dude's not committed. So we got this guy. Oh, hold on. No, not Sparty. Hold on. Penn. Rutgers. OU. Ohio U. That's another. It's his teammates. Duke. Yeah, so him and one of his buddies are a lot of the same schools. Penn State. Yeah, so he's pretty good. BG.
Yeah, I'd say he's pretty good.
Yeah, he's pretty good. So Kilbane, Padilla, Bloodbath, Fockler. Who do you got? You got Padilla or Fockler clearing?
I got Fockler.
Fockler clearing?
Was he a runner-up last year? I think he was.
He
lost
freshman?
The finals. Huh?
Freshman?
Yeah.
Holy smokes.
He lost to Weaver in the finals, I do believe.
Oh, my God. That's wild when you look at some of those draws, dude, how they're able to just like.
Reese Green in the quarters.
Yeah, that's going to be a good one.
In the quarters.
I'll go Ethan Green. Ethan Green's massive, dude. He's 6'7".
6'7"? Come on, man.
Yeah, he's really hard to deal with. He beat Kilbane in the district final.
I think I remember him last year.
Tell me about the Kaufman, dude.
Well, he's a solid position. He's got a slick little single leg, man. You won't even see it coming before your leg's in the air. Note that. I mean, he is slick, man. Always in good position. That's what I got for you. But I think Ethan Green's size is going to be an issue. I mean,
he's a problem. He's like a big problem.
Him versus Fockler. I don't even know. That's what I got.
Is that what you got?
I think Fockler in that just because of his wrestling ability. He's not just just a big guy. He knows how to wrestle. So he's state finalist last year. He's gonna have the experience. He's gonna take Ethan Green in the finals.
Yeah, I'm looking. Hold on. Let me look at that real quick. Hold on, I wanna look at that real quick. So last year Weaver won the weight.
Yeah.
Of Darby, right?
Yep.
Weaver won the weight. He beat Fockler 7-1. I'm going to take Green over Padilla.
Green over Padilla. Hey, a quick question. Okay, there you go. Kilbane needs to come back and get third for his team then.
Yeah, so there you go. They're going to have Giog and Bennett are going to win. Probably. And then little Bennett. So they might only have two champs, but they're going to win with a bunch of thirds and fifths.
That's it. That's what they're going to need.
They're going to have to. Because if Perrysburg has six finalists, like I'm predicting, Perrysburg needs all hands on deck. They need, Noah Ewan's going to have to place. It's going to be closer than you think, man. But I think the difference is going to be the 20 points or the 27 points that they're going to win by, same as a win by, because of Giog's dominance.
Boom, bonus.
That's it. Are you done here?
Dude, we are done. I cannot wait for Friday all day. I'm taking the day off. And good I live in Columbus. I'll be there at 11 o'clock for check-in, boy.
So the ultra-long preview that wasn't super well-researched and out of our hearts and minds. So many people are going to smash us and be like, you're terrible. You're the worst. You suck. I don't care, though.
How did you not call this kid?
You guys didn't even pick these weights. But a lot of rambling, a lot of fun. I hope people make us eat our words on a lot of the picks. It was
fun. Prove us wrong, baby. Hashtag prove us wrong.
Mark Niemann, thank you for the time. I'm uploading this video right now so people can get it out there and smash us or talk or hopefully generate some conversations and people say we overlooked this person or that person. Thank you for the time. I'll catch up with you this week. We'll talk, all right?
Sounds good, man. We'll talk to you later.